This is Comedy Central.
You're not fudging ass, go fudge yourself, fudge again, the fudge out.
Shut the fuck up, man, I'm on the motherfucking telephone.
It's not a family show, all right?
Welcome to English for Managers, Tape 1. Listen and repeat.
Tape 1, listen and repeat.
We will enable timely, knowledge-based decision-making based on real-time information by implementing an enterprise resource management system.
We will entangle timid, college-based precision markets based on full-time repudiation by instigating a something, something, whatever.
Very good.
Really? I thought I missed a word. They say they're slow, but they're not.
Wendy's classic hamburger that's perfect for you, made fresh right off the grill, so it's always hot and juicy. The classic hamburgers at Wendy's, it's better here.
The best Toyota has to offer, like Toyota Corolla, named best compact car in initial quality 3 years in a row. Or the truly different Matrix, a Consumer's Digest Best Buy. Don't miss the best values at your Toyota dealer.
In addition to creamy and dreamy, Cream Savers can now add soft and chewy to its resume. New silky smooth Cream Savers Soft Candy.
I am recruiting you.
For the CIA.
Would I have to kill anyone?
Would you like to?
His job was to recruit the best.
Why me?
You're agile, athletic.
Now.
She's a mole. Find out who she's working for.
He will bring him into a secret world.
You can't trust anyone.
Where nothing is what it seems. Al Pacino.
If you are caught, you're dead.
Colin Farrell. No! The recruit.
Some of you will not survive the final test.
Rated PG-13. See you January 31st.
When life's problems create financial stress, call the law office of Craig V. Kitchen for advice in obtaining a fresh financial start.
It's up to you to reach out to be that friend who comes along.
When you make a friend, you make a difference. Friendship, pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Metal or glass?
I like the metal.
Glass it is. No, 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 dear. Regular or needle nose?
Needle nose?
Get the regular.
Hey, why does she keep doing that?
Last month I chose a satellite dish over digital cable.
Big mistake. Big mistake.
Vertical or horizontal?
I like vertical.
Horizontal.
Oh, for our house.
This is Dave. This is his show. This is your warning.
Steve! What'd I say about hitting so hard, man?
Chappelle's Show, a new brand of comedy. Starts Wednesday at 10:30, only on Comedy Central.
I just want to take this opportunity to thank you all for participating in our company's mandatory blood drive. You really are the lifeblood of this company.
Oh.
Alice, you are like the fresh dew on a morning flower. My heart yearns for you. Your soft skin, your triangle hair, your lips like two tiny sausages stacked upon each other. Death Row is a lonely place, my precious. The only things to occupy the empty hours are thoughts of you and the contraband I have hidden in my colon. My dying wish, Alice, is for your hand in marriage.
That is so romantic.
All my love, Vince. P.S. Please respond before next Friday at noon.
What if I don't have any extra blood? Maybe I only have exactly enough.
Everyone has extra blood.
It doesn't matter anyway. You'll never get past the screening process.
I will now read a list of disqualifying conditions. Please leave the auditorium if any of the following apply to you. Are you now, or have you ever been, Wally?
Yes, first one out.
Repeat. The disconnects between gross margin and leverage will be harnessed for commercial ventures.
The discotheques between gross margarine and beverages will be harmless to your dentures.
Very good. Now close your eyes and visualize each word as you say it. Imagine the word vision. Try to see it in your mind.
Is it black?
Have you gotten any tattoos in the last 6 months? Have you had intimate physical relations with anyone in the past 10 years?
Not really, but I'm trying to build a reputation.
With your eyes still closed, imagine a picture that corresponds with the
clean shot at his tires.
I think I could hit the spare tire in the back.
Wait, he stopped.
Bottles of beer on the wall.
Come on! I can't take another 4 hours of this! Go, go, go! Will you just shut up? You have infinite beer on the wall, okay? It will never be fewer!
Now put your hands out to your sides and wave them slowly.
Can you imagine if something were to happen to this bus helmet?
The sciences of physics, chemistry, mathematics, and medicine are all wiped out in a stroke.
And economics.
Economics is not a science and never will be.
He's waving us on, finally.
All units, he's heading for a large business campus. Prepare to intercept.
Are you telling me you haven't done anything on this list?
I've been very busy.
All right, roll up your sleeve.
Whoa! Isn't that the fifth bag?
We got a quota.
Can I have a cookie?
No, I ate them all while you were bleeding.
All right, sharpshooters, if you get a clear shot, take it.
There's people in the way.
Oh, shoot. Oh, shoot.
I've got to get me a new swear word.
The vehicle had no registration or plates, so we're hoping someone saw him.
Why would a vehicle need registration and plates?
I'm just a sketch artist.
Oh, a specialist. Well, I didn't exactly see the guy, but from what I heard on... Mike.
Can you describe him for me?
I could, but I'm extremely busy. Wally!
I can't work too hard. I almost gave blood today.
I want you to describe to these officers the man I heard about on the radio this morning.
What?
Be as specific as you can. These remind me of water balloons, except filled with blood.
Put that down.
It looks like you have some extras.
All right, one bag, but let me show you how to do it.
This psycho must have left a blood trail. Now, I want you to comb every inch of this area for the killer's DNA. Maybe we'll get lucky. And don't let this crime scene get contaminated.
Die!
Good one, huh?
Nice shooting yourself.
Well, thank you.
Difficult.
Sir, how many drinks have you had this evening?
Nothing. I couldn't even get a cookie. Then a lady took all of my blood.
Okay, buddy. Count backward from 100 using only prime numbers.
97, 89, 83, 79, 73, 71.
Okay, no one likes a wise ass. Get out of the car.
Name match has been made on the Nobel Prize slaughter. The suspect is Caucasian, wearing glasses and laughable.
Now you can help keep your longer. New Crest rejuvenating effects. It strengthens enamel to fight cavities, whitens teeth, and refreshes gums with a tingly sensation. Rejuvenating effects? I'll take it.
The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine?
Introducing the GMC Envoy XL.
You've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine.
The midsize SUV engineered to comfortably seat seven full-size adults.
Underway. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine?
What's it like to crunch it to a twix? Creamy, creamy, chewy, crunchy, crunchy, cookie. Crunchy. Twix.
It's all in the mix.
Some crazy vendetta.
Rated M for mature.
You rely on shampoos to care for your hair. But what about dandruff? Head & Shoulders Anti-Dandruff Shampoo. The only shampoo with micro-ZPT. It works directly on your scalp to help stop dandruff where it starts. So your scalp is flake-free. And your hair looks and feels beautiful. Head & Shoulders Shampoo for hair that is beautiful and flake-free.
This shot for the cop and a piece of hurling history. What must be going through that young man's head? Young man's head, young man's head. Shh.
Has he got what it takes to be a champion?
Now, from Comedy Central on DVD, the first season of South Park Collector's Edition. Special features include Cartman's rendition of Oh Holy Night. And if you buy it now at ComedyCentral.com for only $39.99, you'll get five CDs of exclusive audio commentary from the creators for free.
Tonight at 11, hate your neighbors? Imagine living next to this.
What is this noise you're hearing? Leaf blower, loud music?
Horrible explosions.
Stephen Colbert exposes America's noisiest neighbor. The Daily Show with Jon Stewart, tonight at 11, only on Comedy Central.
So with the Nobel Prize killer safely behind bars, looking at a swift execution, once the 40 to 75 years of appeals is over and everyone associated with the case long dead, strange men with incomprehensible theories that can't be proven can once again breathe a sigh of relief.
Mr. and Mrs. Fennerman? Hi, I'm Alice. I'm engaged to your son, Vince.
It is so nice to meet you, darling.
Here, do you need a sign?
That's okay, I have my own.
I don't understand. Aren't you two getting married?
Yes. We're going to spend the rest of our lives together.
Mark my words, this marriage will never last.
Wow. This cell is huge.
Sorry about the internet connection.
There's an internet connection?
Your cable modem's in the shop. We're running you through the T1 until it gets back.
What's this?
Fan mail. Probably a few marriage proposals.
For me? Marriage proposals?
You're in for murder, right? That's an aphrodisiac for the fairer sex.
You know, I'm actually innocent.
No, I wouldn't let that slip out.
Excuse me, how did you decide that five cigarettes was worth one candy bar?
Well, I was hungry.
First of all, you should never barter on an empty stomach. Second, this is much too inefficient. So, everything used for barter could be valued at a constant rate relative to everything else. For instance, a shampoo bottle of homemade gin is equal to a clean toothbrush, which is also equivalent to an 8-ounce bar of chocolate. Or five cigarettes. Any questions? Okay. One might wonder what happens when a scarcity in a perishable commodity, say chocolate, causes a relative glut of another more durable item, such as erotic literature. Anyone? Yes.
We carve a potato into the shape of a gun and cover it with shoe polish?
You could do that. Or wait for the market to automatically adjust to take into account the commodity imbalance, thus moving the exchange rate to a new point of stability.
And you can do all that without a potato?
Hey.
Chocolate, no cigarettes!
How about 8NGY432?
Let me check.
Boys, you're sitting on a gold mine here. Do you realize the license plate business is a growth industry and a legal monopoly? By automating your order flow and assembly process, you'll increase productivity and reduce costs.
The guy who had this job before didn't train me.
Dead man walking! Down the aisle.
We are gathered here today to join two souls in holy matrimony and to damn one of them to eternal hellfire. I understand that you two have written your own vows.
Vince, who would have thought 10 years ago that a grisly mass murderer would lead to such a blissful union? You are my heart. You are my soul. You make living worthwhile. I look forward to spending the next 45 seconds as your loving wife.
Vince.
I didn't do it! Oh, for
the love of God, please don't kill me!
Right. Okay. By the authority vested in me by the state correctional facility, I pronounce you man and wife. You may now insert the gag.
You're making a big mistake! Oh, I didn't!
It is an incredible book, Mr. Dogbert.
Thanks. It took me all morning to write it.
It's the ending that bothers me. It would be better if this Dilbert fellow gets set free at the last minute instead of flaming like a marshmallow.
How much better would it be?
About $3 million in movie rights.
I'll talk to the Supreme Court.
Oh, there are just no good convicts out there.
And that one's cute.
Cute, yes, but he's got a damn good appeal pending. I read the brief.
Oh, you can't tell anything from a picture anyway. In my high school yearbook, I didn't even look attractive.
Maybe we should go visit Dilbert. Check the place out.
That sounds like it involves leaving work. I'll drive.
I couldn't help overhearing you while I was eavesdropping. Do you mind if I go with you to stare at the miserable miscreant?
There's no room in my car. It's filled with oxygen and carbon dioxide.
That's not good. I'll drive my own car. Can you give me directions?
Yes. Yes, I can.
Ooh. Ooh.
Who's that?
He's an axe murderer.
Ooh, the outdoor type.
Let me talk to Wally.
Put in a good word for me in C-Block.
Hey, Dilbert, looking good. All that hard manual labor's paying off.
Actually, there is no hard labor. I have all day to think, to exercise, and to work on my own projects. I barely have to do anything if I don't want to.
But it's lonely, right?
Hardly. Wally, this week alone, I've received over 100 marriage proposals.
Boy, is my value system all screwed up.
There it is, bars and all.
The big house.
Okay, next we'll hear from Tino in Shiv Manufacturing.
Thank you. I'm pleased to report that since we instituted a battle recycling program, the number of pointy objects available to the prison population has tripled.
Good work. Bobby G., you're up.
I just prepared this memo on the new production quotas. As you can see, all the inmates are participating in the prison 401k. Considering the average inmate's salary is 18 cents a day, at maturity, this amounts to a retirement package of approximately $34.
Well, let's see if we can't supplement that with some of the souvenir sales. All right. Is there any new business?
I think we should probably discuss the status of the escape plan and the progress of the tunnel.
All right.
Using two shifts round the clock and a teaspoon, we have dug approximately 3 feet. At this rate of excavation, we estimate the tunnel will be completed sometime in the year 2125.
And when is the escape currently scheduled?
Tuesday.
Okay. I've done some calculations, along with a preliminary geological survey, and Tony? Shirt. The bearing wall is made of basalt. Basalt is among the most dense of igneous rocks. Now, if we drop down approximately 10 meters, the composition of the bordering wall becomes limestone, a very spoon-friendly material. Now, I've drawn up plans for an electric spoon, but it's going to cost 4 million candy bars.
No problem.
Did you know that I'm the only one in my bridge club with a son on death row?
I'm sorry I'm such a disappointment to you, Mom.
Disappointment? Everyone asks about you. You're on the news. I used to get blank stares when I told people you were an engineer. But murderer? That gets people's respect.
You could be a little disappointed.
Let's see. Bank robbery, 10 to 15 years. Kidnapping, 20 to life. Not too shabby. Frotourism, the crime of rubbing up against people in crowded public places. When did they make that illegal?
Dogbert, always a pleasure. Why don't you come to the meetings anymore?
I'm not actually a member of the Supreme Court.
Really? Now I feel bad about letting you write all those decisions.
I didn't mind.
What brings you in today?
I want you to overturn the conviction of a guilty murderer named Dilbert. If you don't mind, I'll just write up your decision and sign all your names to it.
Okay, but make me sound indignant. And throw something in there about fairness.
Do you want a copy?
I don't see when I'd ever read it.
Today, my friends, marks the dawning of a new era. Today we prove that with vigor, discipline, and a little... Yeah!
I guess it works.
What's your name?
Good Lord, man. What's happened to you in there?
Okay, time to go, Dilbert.
But they're coming back, aren't they?
Probably. The recidivism rate is very high.
Did they ever find the real killer?
Funny thing. Right after I got you off, some lunatic confessed to the crime.
You sure is good at not being able to hammer up them rocks at all.
I wasn't really expecting this kind of an environment. Ooh, are those the conjugal visit trailers?
We's a team, you and me. Got us a quote. If and we ain't meet her by sundown, we ain't getting no dinner.
So, you get a lot of marriage proposals since you've been here?
You hear me up, boy? I ain't missing my shower day. Account of your baby butt hands can't swing a pick. Grab up that there pick and bring her down. No, that ain't gonna do her. Here, let me show you. Now you're getting it.
I think my shoulders are dislocating.
That's enough out of you.
Ooh, I like steak and chicken.
He likes melted cheese.
I like skillet sensations.
You're back at Applebee's.
Eating good in the neighborhood.
17 years ago, Honda engineers set out on a dream to create something with unprecedented mobility and feet. One day it may be the eyes, ears, and legs for people in need. Say hello to Osmo.
Imagine a world where automobile painting robots would have absolutely nothing to do. Because of a revolutionary color-infused, scratch-resistant Lexan plastic that just might make automobile painting a thing of the past.
Attention all painting robots, please report to the crash dummy testing facility immediately.
GE Plastics. For us, it's never just another day in the factory. GE. Imagination at work.
Check out Chappelle's show. I am not Chris Rock.
By the power vested in me by the state correctional facility, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may now insert the gag. Yellow. It's the governor. The real killer confessed. You've been pardoned.
Now we can start a life together, Alice. It's like a miracle.
You're innocent? I'm having serious second thoughts.
The governor wants to speak to you.
Tell him to hold for 1 minute.
Oh, which one is the hold button?
Thank you.
we're flying, and there's no denying we're driving.
Happy Hour rocks! Talk about your king's banquet.
I don't think this chicken is cooked, Mike.
That's why it's free. Hey, I'll take another one of those $8 beers, please.
Uh-oh, I gotta hit the John again.
Don't worry, buddy. That's just your stomach adjusting to life on the road.
Be right back.
Hey, better hurry if we're gonna catch the all-you-can-eat clam steak buffet at Thank God It's Wednesdays. I guess I just sort of naturally fell into the leadership role. It's always been like that for me.
Hey, Mike, come here. You gotta see this.
Everybody's really counting on me to get us over the top. Oh, my God, Ben!
How'd your brother get on road rage?
Lucky bastard.
What the hell have I been doing wrong? So in conclusion, I think I'd be perfect for road rage. Am I hip enough? Hell yes, dog. Let's kick it freestyle. Yeah. He looks good.
Now that he's dropped the JCPenney look.
These people have become like my soulmates. It's so perfect. The trip is ending in Santa Fe because it's so, like, super spiritual.
Great Spirit is, like, so super pleased that you won the Jello Shot Marathon. You are all now 40 points closer to your fully loaded SUVs.
Yes. Yeah. Cool.
Izzy rocked with the Jello Shots, man. It was so cool of her to fall off the wagon so we could win.
What's more important, sobriety or getting more points for the SUVs? So I took one for the group.
Brother Eagle now requests that you get your freak on at our casino nightclub dances with laps.
We should hook up with him, man. Santa Fe is only like 18 hours away. We could be there in like 18 hours!
Are you kidding me? It's always been my dream to be on a road show.
Yeah, right. What would it be called? Mike and Gary?
So this guy did your daughter.
On her wedding day.
Oh, man.
Thanks. I've been tracking that son of a for months. I was so close, and then suddenly, poof, he's gone. It's like he's vanished from the face of the earth.
We've got 12 hours to find the organs and get them to Santa Fe General.
If we don't make it, guys, those orphans are toast.
You magnificent bastard. You went undercover.
Wing me.
Coming right up. Dip.
You know it, Daddy. I can't wait to see the look on Ben's face. He's gonna freak.
When was the last time you saw him?
I'll kill you!
No, I'll kill you!
Bring it on!
Christmas, 2 years ago.
There's just something about Ben, the way he dresses, the stories he tells. I'm starting to think he could so be the one I lose it to. Oh my God, I can't believe I just said that.
I'm definitely tight with Kira, yeah. But now that I got to know everybody individually, I'm starting to think of everybody as individuals.
I'm not so much a stand-up comic as a satiritist. I hold up a funhouse mirror to society.
Everyone's been really supportive of my weight issues. I finally feel okay about who I am. Who I am is a girl who needs to lose maybe 15 pounds. Maybe 30 pounds. What do you think?
Everyone's cool, but I feel so alone. There's no one here I could talk to about my sexuality. I'm really confused.
A few more days and it's like blue sky, baby. Ain't nothing gonna stop us now. Hey, brother, kiss my hairy ass!
Oh, no!
Hey, Ben! How the hell are you, man?
Mike? Great to see you, man.
I am not confused anymore. I know exactly what I want.
I can't believe I'm actually on the road rage bus doing a confessional. Everybody here's been so totally cool. Especially Nate. Nate, is it?
Man, what are you doing here?
Hey, you're my big brother! I saw you on TV! Thought I'd come and say hey. Hey, is that my jacket?
When I first saw Ben, he asked me what I was doing here. And I said, you're my big brother, saw you on TV. Thought I'd come by and say hey. At that point, I think I said, hey, is that my jacket?
He's my little brother and I love him. But what you need to know about Mike is that he's very insecure. He's always got to be the center of attention. It's sad, really.
Let me introduce you to everyone. No, I got it. That's drunk girl,
black comic guy, fat chick, gay guy,
and hello. That must make you the virgin. First thing Mike did was reduce everyone to a complete stereotype, which, you know, I thought was kind of rude.
First thing I did was reduce everyone to a complete stereotype, which I thought was really funny.
And who's sitting next to me in a Mexican jail cell on New Year's Eve? Robert Downey Jr. What? That's my best story.
Can I talk to you alone, Mike?
It felt so sad when Mike stole Ben's story.
If we don't have honesty, we'll never make it.
You stole my story. Hey, you know how it is. You're sitting around having drinks. Oh, come on, I'm sorry, Mike. Just let it slide, okay? I got something really good going here. Yeah, all right. Well, at least it's nice to see you finally got some friends.
Cold?
A little.
Share my blanket?
Oh, thanks.
He said thanks. He didn't have to, but he did.
Well, we better pack it in and get some sleep, gang. I guess you and Gary have a long drive ahead of you tonight.
Actually, we were thinking we might just hang with you guys.
I don't think that's a good idea. We've got another mission tomorrow.
Wait a minute. We just can't send them off in the middle of the night. It's night.
But there isn't enough room on the bus.
We'll make room.
Then it's settled, Ben. We're here.
Original shows.
Original shows.
Every night at 10.
Every night.
Only on Comedy Central.
10 o'clock.
Find them here.
You will find them here.
Stop saying what I'm saying.
Stop saying what I'm saying.
Stop it.
Stop it.
I hate you.
I hate you.
You're ugly.
No, you're ugly.
I'm the voice of Comedy Central.
I'm the voice of Comedy Central.
Give me your mic. That's my script now.
The greatest duos of all time have always come in pairs. Adam and Eve, Romeo and Juliet, Beavis and Butthead. Now together again for the first time in one awesome collection, the best of Beavis and Butthead.
I am Cornholio. I need TV for my bunghole.
Relive the golden moments with the comic masters.
Number one, I order you to go take a number two.
Aye, aye, Captain. Does not the fire need water too? Does not the mountain need the storm? Does not your skin need kicking?
Get four complete volumes of the best of Beavis and Butthead on two VHS or two DVDs for only $29.99.
I'm like angry at numbers.
There's like too many of them and stuff.
Call in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and you'll also get Beavis and Butthead's Holiday Extravaganza featuring Butt-O-Ween. And Beavis and Butthead Do Christmas absolutely free. Your spirits will rise.
I love you. Come to Butthead.
You will howl till it hurts. You will be choking back the tears of joy. We guarantee you'll laugh long and hard.
Long, hard.
Or we'll refund your purchase price.
We have a winner.
So call in the next 10 minutes with your credit card to experience their genius again and again.
I have seen the top of the mountain. And it is good.
You'll get 42 incredible episodes on three VHS or DVDs for only $29.99.
Yes!
Cool.
This offer is only available right here.
Would you like to pet my poopy?
So call now.
Use your credit card and call 1-800-326-0303 to order Beavis and Butthead on 3 VHS or 3 DVDs for just $29.99 plus shipping and handling. Or send check or money order to Beavis and Butthead, Department 1, Richmond, Virginia, 23280. Call now.
When your satellite equipment breaks and you realize how much it's going to cost to fix, and you find out there's, like, nobody who knows how to fix it, just think of all the things you'll get to do with your dish. With Charter Digital Cable, you get the channels you want. Great movies, music, sports, and more, without the hassle and expense that come with owning a dish. No expensive service charges, no broken dishes, only with Charter Digital Cable.
Wakey wake, road ragers. I see you picked up some stragglers. I hope they cheer you on in your next mission. You're really going to fall for it.
When we get over the field, you jump and aim for the target. If you land on the bullseye, you get 100 points. You must amass 200 points to move on to your next mission.
Okay, I so hate to admit this, but it was so totally sexy that Mike had the balls to get on that plane. Oh my God, I so can't believe I just said balls. Oh my God, I just said it again. Oh my God.
So, are you okay?
Never better. Why?
Ben told us all about your fear of flying.
My fear of flying?
Ben, let's go.
Let me think about it.
Do it.
The whole team has to jump or you lose.
I'm too scared.
Then we'll jump together.
Mike!
I'm scared too.
In hindsight, when they were handing out the parachutes, I probably shouldn't have lied about my weight. What do you think?
You ever notice white people jump out of planes for fun? Yo, only time you see a brother jump out of plane is when that mother's on fire. And he probably hijacked that bitch. Y'all know what I'm saying, right?
My suit isn't gonna pack itself.
Man, chest bump, what? Ow! That was nice.
Oh my God, it was so the most exciting experience of my life. And it was so because of Mike.
I would have hit the 100, but there was a problem with my ripcord, okay? Thanks for helping us get the points. Yeah, it was a little tough though. What with me being afraid of flying and all. Well, look, since I stole your jail story, I figured it was only fair that I give you my fear of flying. But we're cool, right? Not really.
Ben and Mike are, like, totally stressing, and it's totally affecting all of us. So I think what everybody needs is some cocktails.
I think I love you. Isn't that what life is made of? Though it worries me to say that I never felt this way.
Ooh. You know, you really have it together for a guy who's bipolar.
Okay, let me guess. Ben told you that? What else has he said about me?
Compulsive liar.
Clubfooted.
Tone deaf.
Bedwetter. See, when a white guy wets a bed, it's like, here I am, wet in the bed. Now, when a black man wets the bed, he does damage, right?
You trashed my rep to these guys.
What do you care what they think? They're my friends.
Oh, really? Well, we'll see about that.
Okay, it's go time.
Yeah, bring it on.
It's now or never. Come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight. Now or never, my love away.
Who's the choir geek now?
Oh, yeah? Well, it ain't over till the bipolar, tone-deaf, club-footed, compulsive, lying, bedwetting baby brother sings.
Yeah! Wow!
Ben?
I'm quitting the show. Say bye to Kira for me.
From New York, this is a Daily Show News Break. Now, John Stewart.
Good evening. Seriously, it's a really good evening. Protesters around the world demonstrate against the U.S.-led war in Iraq until the police come by with their sirens all, if the protests were all in Britain. Plus, Colin Powell splits with the president on affirmative action. Now Bush has to ignore Powell on domestic issues as well.
Irresistibly mellow new cheese Ritz. Bet you can't wait to try them.
Want some, Dad?
There's no place like Ritz.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Stop!
Tim here is on his first date. And his family has some advice. With T-Mobile, families can talk all they want.
Oh. Hello?
Let her win.
Hello?
Tell her she smells nice.
Hello?
Does she come from money?
Hello?
Does she have a sister?
Wrong number.
Families talk free. Additional lines just $10. Only from T-Mobile.
Get more.
What do you care? You've got the goodness of Reese's peanut butter and milk chocolate. Get lost in a Reese's.
The 75 Civic was first in Honda's long line of clean cars. Today, every car we build is a low-emission vehicle or better. And we're planning for tomorrow with our zero-emission fuel cell vehicle. Is it any wonder Honda was recently named the cleanest car company in the world?
Miss last night's Conan?
I don't really care, one way or the other.
Then catch it tonight.
Hi.
And every weeknight at 7, here on Comedy Central.
We've got a problem. Ben's leaving.
He'll be fine.
I don't think so. He's quitting the show.
All right, whatever. I'll go talk to him. Gary came to me and said, Mike, we've got a problem. Ben's leaving. I said he'll be fine. Then Gary said, I don't think so. He's quitting the show. So I said, all right, whatever. I'll go talk to him. So I did. What's the problem?
You are.
Me? What did I do?
What you always do. You came in and stole my thunder.
You stole my life.
Not your whole life. I didn't take the part where you're an asshole.
Oh, come on.
No, you won. Everyone likes you better, so enjoy it. It's all yours.
All right, fine, go. And give me my jacket back.
Take it.
What the hell happened?
Ben just bailed.
Who could blame him?
Wait a minute, you're taking his side? Freaking believable.
Do you mind? This is kind of personal. I gotta tell you, Mike, I understand what he's been going through.
Oh, I know exactly what he's been going through. My wardrobe, my stories, my whole freaking life.
Would you please? This really has nothing to do with this show. thank you. I just realized why you came here. You're jealous.
Of what?
Of Ben. He's on road rage. He's hooking up with Kira. He's getting all the attention. Come on, Mike. The most obvious thing stares you right in the face, and you can't see it.
I've drawn you a bath gear.
Thanks, Nath. For once, Ben's the star, and you can't deal. Ugh. Look, man, you're really starting to piss me off. I mean, think about it from Ben's point of view. His whole life, he's been nothing but Mike Bonner's brother.
Carl Benson, Jenny Blyer, Mike Bonner's brother.
For outstanding individual achievement, Mike Bonner's brother.
Oh, Mike Bonner's brother.
You're always taking over, Mike. You don't care who it affects as long as it's good for you.
Yeah, but... I guess you're right. When Ben comes back, I'll apologize.
You're doing the right...
Oh, now, come on!
Wiki Wake, Road Ragers! Final mission time. Since you spent the past 3 months wrestling with your demons, we thought we'd give you something else to wrestle with.
WWF Champion China!
Oh, and one other thing? All six of you must compete or you forfeit everything, and your precious SUVs will become a distant memory.
Wait, where's Ben?
Yo, he didn't come back.
Without Mike Bonner's brother, we are so screwed.
First that punk lied to us and now he sold us out.
Ben just wasted 3 months of my life.
Yeah! Who's Ben again?
The a-hole who's about to blow this for us.
Hey, that's enough. My brother's a man of his word. And I'm telling you, he will not let you guys down.
Is Ben here yet?
Any minute now.
Unless he shows right now, you're going to have to...
Get ready to kick some serious ass!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the WWF Tag Team Elimination Match. Here she is, the First Lady of Wrestling, China!
Get through with you.
You know the rules. Only two road rages can wrestle at a time. Let's get it on!
I'll go first. Who's with me?
Ebony and Ivory. Let's break us up some China!
Hey, China, are you a parking ticket?
No, why?
Because you've got fine written all over you.
Mike?
That's it, you pig.
Mike, it's you.
Chappelle Show, that's me.
Hi, kids.
It's the sketch comedy show that's not afraid to take on, well, just about everything.
Perfect.
Chappelle Show, a new brand of comedy. Starts Wednesday at 10:30, only on Comedy Central.
When my family loves what we're eating, we talk about it.
So this is new? What's it called?
Chicken castellina.
The sauce is delicious.
Smoked cheese is giving a great flavor.
The sun-dried tomatoes.
Each menu fine. Great price.
Okay, enough talking. Let's eat.
Olive Garden. When you're here, you're family.
She won't come in the light.
Who?
You know who.
He won't sleep, not even for 10 minutes at a time.
We stay in the light, we stay alive.
Them put him in the dark.
Critics are calling Darkness Falls a terrifying thrill ride. Darkness Falls. Rated PG-13.
Stay alive.
Opens everywhere Friday.
Introducing all new America Online 8.0. We listened to you and designed AOL 8.0 with hundreds of exciting new features.
Welcome.
Like the new online photo albums to instantly share pictures. And AOL alerts and reminders that alert you of important dates. Plus new and easier parental controls to help safeguard your kids. There are hundreds of new features to easily connect you to the people and things you care about most. New America Online 8.0. Call 1-800-4-ONLINE or get a free startup disk at these locations.
Are you burdened by too much credit card debt?
When I was dealing with the credit card companies, I felt like I was worthless. They made me feel as if I didn't want to pay my bills.
They would call sometime late at night. It just was very uncomfortable to have them call all the time.
What if you could cut your credit card interest rate dramatically?
I had a couple accounts go to 0%. Some went to 6%, some went to 9%.
a lot more of the money went to the balances.
What if you could cut your total monthly payments by one-third or more?
My payments were roughly around $500. And just here recently, my payment has dropped down to $277.
$840 and dropped down to $460.
Slash interest rates, reduce payments, and get out of debt much faster with the Debt Relief Clearinghouse.
It's a relief off my shoulders.
I'm out of debt. I can breathe easier.
I finally have control over my debt. It's finally going away.
Call the number on your screen to dramatically lower your interest rates and get out of debt. Call the Debt Relief Clearinghouse now.
I know what you're looking for.
When you look down at your shoes, to the door.
Look anywhere but in my eyes.
You're looking for an excuse.
Una excusa.
Some lame.
No good.
Irresponsible.
Bad talking.
Excuse. For fooling around. For doing it without using protection.
Now, what was your excuse?
I've heard that one before.
For more information about HIV/AIDS, call toll-free 1-866-344-NO.
One way to St. Louis.
Aren't you Mike Bonner's brother from Road Rage?
Yeah.
How can you be here when you're there?
What?
Excuse me, miss?
You want some of me?
Does anybody else see four Bens?
All right, who's the real Ben?
Me! Stop it, Mike. I'll make this short. All of the stories I've told you guys, well, they weren't mine. Yes, they were. Remember that time
Mike,
you... enough lying. You've always been the cool one, and I've always been, well, just Mike Bonner's brother. I came back to come clean and tell everyone I'm... Well, I'm sorry. Especially to you. No. If anybody should be sorry, it's me.
I'm sorry too.
When Ben was honest with us, he was so vulnerable, so real. I suddenly so want him to be my first again. Oh my God, I can't believe I just said that.
All right, that's four double cheeseburgers, two orders of chili fries with cheese, and one jumbo salad in a sack.
I guess now that I won my SUV and the cameras aren't going to be on me anymore, I don't care what I look like. What do you think?
When a white man gets his back broken, it's like, oh golly, my back is broken. But when a black man gets his back broken, he sues road rage for every cent they got. Call Johnny Cochran. Call Al Sharpton.
This is my car, and I'm okay to drive.
I'm not confused anymore. I now know exactly what I want. Help me.
So, you're okay? For the first time in my life, I'm liked for being Ben. Thanks, Mike.
No problem, bro. Well, there's my ride. I'm out of here. Oh, and the next time I drop by, I'll be sure to call first. Later! Dinner is served.
You know, Mike, that was a really nice thing you did for your brother back there.
Yeah. For once, I think I left him in a pretty good place.
Well, Kira, that's not just the smell of a new car. It's the smell of a new beginning. What was that?
Pay your prayers, Mike Bonner!
I gotta tell you, when I found out I had critically wounded Mike Bonner's brother, well, sir, I felt like so super conflicted. Oh my God, I can't believe that I just said that.
You're watching Comedy Central. If you thought freshman year was rough, wait till you see it animated. Stick around for Undergrads, coming up next.
think we should get back together. Dumping you was a big mistake. A big, big... Oh, you're so freaking sexy. You have the roundest, sweetest, most incredible...
Rocco, why are you calling my daughter at this hour? Do you have any idea what time it is?
No. Do you?
Whatever you have to tell her can certainly wait until this weekend when she's down there visiting State U.
Mom, hang up the phone! Hang up! Rocco, are you high?
Depends on what you're wearing.
Stop calling me and leaving drunk messages on my machine, jackass! What?
Could you put your mom back on the phone? She sounded kind of sexy.
So come and talk to me on my computer screen. The best years of our lives aren't as easy as they seem. To get the girl and make the grade, it's all a show, it's all a game, and I would lose it if I played. But anyway, you go out.
Watch my special, Tongue Untied, baby. If you miss it, you the biggest jerk in the world, you dumb bastard.
Wanda Sykes, Tongue Untied, premieres Friday at 10, only on Comedy Central. What if the new Kia Sorento was in a race against the other SUVs? Who would win? The little ones would be left in the dust. Some just too honking huge. Others would be afraid of getting dirty. And the rest, they'd be distracted by the wads of cash we see. The midsize Sorento with a 10-year warranty won this unbiased race. After all, it is our commercial. Right now, get 0% financing on the new Kia Sorento. They may be security guards.
Nobody throw their gum on the ground, okay? We get like a warning.
But when it all goes down,
they're getting away, man.
They go off. Martin Lawrence.
I'm a one-man kung fu squad team. You start talking about my mama.
National security.
National security! Get out of the damn car!
Didn't your mama teach you any manners? At least you could ask me nicely.
Rated PG-13. In theaters January 17th.
Iron Maiden. Edward the Great. The Greatest Hits. The new compilation from the band that set the standard for hard rock. Featuring 16 of the best tracks spanning Iron Maiden's entire career. Edward the Great includes all the hits, like The Number of the Beast, Run to the Hills, The Trooper, The Wicker Man, and many more. This is the definitive Iron Maiden collection. Receive a limited edition Edward the Great poster. Supplies are limited, so act fast. Iron Maiden. Edward the Great. The greatest hits. Call the number on your screen now. Rush delivery is available. Up the irons.
Summer's here, and there's no better time to get in shape. Well, now you can with Fitness Made Simple's Summer Meltdown Special. Melt that fat away with our two best-selling videos. Fitness Made Simple and Six Pack Abs, hosted by fitness celebrity John Baystyle.
This video gives you the exact blueprint to build the body of your dreams. The exercise routine, what to eat, it's all in this one tape.
I look like that 3 weeks before starting Fitness Made Simple, and this is me now. It's amazing how fast it works.
If you want a defined midsection, nothing beats Six Pack Abs. Forget ab gadgets and gizmos. This video provides three at-home ab workouts plus fat-fighting nutritional tips to help build the lean, toned abs you've always wanted.
Sold separately, each of these videos costs $29.95, but for a limited time, now you can get both Fitness Made Simple and Six Pack Abs for just one payment of $29.95. And if you order right now, you'll also get this audio tape on the most effective fat loss supplements free. Call now or order online at our website, fitnessmadesimple.com.
Thanks for coming to the Safe Sex Floor Meeting. I'm super proud to see all my residents take this issue as seriously as I do.
Your flyer stated there would be chips and soda available. I highlighted the relevant sections.
Look, everyone! I made an ostrich!
Hey, Nitz, you accidentally dropped your safe sex pamphlet and free condoms in the trash.
Oh, did I? Thanks, Jesse.
God, Betsy. Would Jonah like me better if I wore thong underwear and put out? Ew.
Listen up, homies. The Duggler's gonna rap serious with you for a second. Date rape is no laughing matter.
Oh, Garfield. How are you ever gonna eat that much lasagna?
Peeps.
Oh, sorry.
Like I was saying, date rape, no laughing matter. To illustrate this point, here's a reenactment skit from Health Services. Peace out.
Oh my god, what's Rocco doing here?
Who are you talking to?
Well, here we are. Insert actress's name. Would you like to come up to my room?
I don't know. I don't really know you.
You know I got a futon and a boner. What more do you need?
Freeze. Now what's going on here? What should... Rocco, I said freeze.
But I haven't even copped a feel yet. What kind of crappy date rape is this?
That was such a joke. My mother talks about sex more maturely. And she uses words like pee-pee and bunny hole.
Annette, what does promiscuous mean?
People who sleep with lots of people, Cal.
Ah, phew, guy. Good thing I never slept with any of my lady friends. We just played a little game I like to call unprotected sex.
And here's the star of our show now.
Oh, that stupid idiot fired me.
Why were you even in that skit in the first place? You don't go to our school.
My ex is coming to check out State U. So I need to find a girl to make her jealous. And I thought a date rape sketch thing would be a good way to meet chicks.
Rocco had a girlfriend? Was she mentally challenged or like a man or something? Okay, fine. For the sake of conversation, let's say your ex wasn't a total whack job. Why'd you break up?
It's sort of complicated. I know it's prom and all, but I'm breaking up with you so I can get laid by tons of chicks when I go to college. Oh yeah, happy birthday!
Hey guys, what are you talking about?
How Rocco dumped his ex.
Yeah, how dumb was that? He'll never get laid again in his life. Great news! I've created a program that allows me to hack into any PC and install a Gillian Anderson screensaver. Watch.
Sexy Miss Scully. I wonder if she ever had gonorrhea.
Real great, Gimpy.
Yeah, great if you're a freaking nerd.
Hey, peeps. Super screensaver. Listen, I've read all of the sex pamphlets thoroughly, so if you have any questions about what you've heard tonight, my door is always open.
I got a question. Why are you such a wad?
I do not see you, I do not hear you, I will not let you get in the Duggler's head with your bring down.
Yeah, right. Like I would ask the Duggler anything about sex? He's a total VID. Virgin in denial.
How do you know?
Come on, you can tell someone's a virgin just by looking at them.
Why aren't any of you looking at my Scully screensaver? Look at it! Look at it!
We've seen it, Gimpy.
But only with your eyes and not your heart.
So, you wanna have sex?
You tried that one yesterday, Einstein.
Oh, sorry. All chicks look alike to me.
Jesse doesn't know what she's talking about. You can't tell a person is a virgin just by looking at them. I mean, I don't look like a virgin. Do I? Cal?
Spreads quickly, leaving boils on the penis. Boy, I hope I don't...
Kimmy! What are you doing?
Hi, Nitz. Oh, I volunteer as a big sister to inner-city kids twice a week. Today we're finger painting.
My mommy shot my daddy because she loves me.
Mm-hmm.
I also volunteer at the Cancer Ward, Amnesty International, the Free Clinic, Greenpeace, the Free Tibet Organization, UNICEF.
She's done.
She's so pure and good. Don't you see? She's like the Virgin Kimmy.
Dudes, stop talking all this virgin crap and help me find a slut.
Ah, sorry, lady. No can do. What if you have something bad that burns?
Hello.
Oh.
Cal bad, me good. Sex, you wanna have? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Ew, oh, I think he touched my arm.
Let me see if I understand. No one cares about my screensaver, yet you're all content to drone on for hours about this new obsession you have with sex. Girls are the enemy, end of story.
Well, not all girls.
All girls.
Even Rosie O'Donnell?
All girls.
Dude, what about Scully?
Agent Dana Scully is a woman of reason, science, and sharp Armani suits. She's a sterling example of American womanhood, untouchable by human hands.
Well, except for Mulder's.
The hell?
Yeah, dude. You know Mulder and Scully totally do the nasty.
Blasphemers! Ooh. You will rue the day you besmirched the sanctity of Agent Scully.
Free condoms. What about free self-restraint? No one would have to wait in line to pick up some free morals, would they?
Talking loud is fun! Thanks for coming to the health center with me while I get tested, best buddy.
Yeah, well, anything to stop you from quoting STD pamphlets in your sleep.
As a general rule, we advise all patients not to have sex until your test results come back.
For a whole hour?
No, for a couple of days.
Ah, phew. You scared me for a second.
Sorry I'm late, but I've been running around all day and... This is totally boring, right? Anyway, I'll take 1,000 condoms, some lubricated, some unlubricated. Oh, and the ribbed ones are great. Oh, hi, Nitz. How are you?
No.
Check out Chappelle's show. I am not Chris Rock.
Hot Sims, hot tubs, hot action. Brace yourself. The Sims are on PlayStation 2. Rated T for teen.
EA Games.
Challenge everything.
Life may not be as easy as pushing a button. But with e-file from the IRS, your taxes can be. It's the fastest, surest way to get your taxes behind you. So ask your tax preparer or visit us on the web.
Big old Michael Strahan! You ain't got nothing! How about them cowboys?
Forgetting you're in New York, another unfortunate side effect of hunger. Grab a Snickers, peanuts, caramel, and chocolate. Hungry? Grab a Snickers.
You forgot your hat!
Introducing the all-new E-Class. You may never want to leave it.
Who are you?
Your guardian angel. You forgot to dial 1-800-COLLECT.
Oh, 1-800-COLLECT for collect calls.
He gets it.
Oh, I get it. I do now.
Good boy. Gotta fly.
1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
Take average, ordinary people and put them on actual blind dates with celebrities.
I've never been with two girls. Six, that's different.
That's Star Dates on E! Where you never know who's gonna end up in love.
I'm not competitive with the guys I date.
And who's gonna love ending the date.
If they call me Duty, you're out of here.
Star Dates, a match made in Hollywood or a date from hell. This weekend, only on E!
In Living Color, I used to watch all the time.
I wasn't on that.
Comedy Central has the Conan.
It's like romper room in here. Yay!
Every weeknight at 7, Comedy Central's got the same outrageous Conan.
I got needs, chicken legs.
Late Night with Conan O'Brien. Every weeknight at 7 on Comedy Central.
What an idiot! Kimmy's a virgin like me. How stupid!
Hey, guy. Oh, you're fast.
Yeah, not as fast as Kimmy. If she wants to behave like a indiscriminate, fine. But not me. I'm gonna show all the Kimmys of this world that I'm proud to be a virgin.
Yay, me too. I'm a virgin now too, guy.
Oh, now you want my help. The same man who hours ago defamed Scully the Pure.
Come on, Kim. My ex is coming this weekend and I can't find a girl. You're smart. I need you to think of something.
Tell you what. I'll help you if you promise to take back what you said about Scully and allow me to broadcast your retraction over the net.
Fine, fine. Anything.
Please sign and initial this release form at the exit. We'll order you a bride online. You can use her to make your ex-girlfriend jealous, then simply return her to her war-torn Eastern European country within 7 days for a complete refund.
Hello. My name is Petrova Nablyovka. My father, mother, brother, and 2 sisters have all been killed in the fight for liberation. I enjoy cooking for soldiers, sewing up bullet wounds and walks before curfew.
Dude, she's hot. I want her.
That'll be $16,000, plus shipping and handling.
Do they take Midas muffler points?
No, Visa and MasterCard only.
Damn.
Oh, well, we tried. Now, if you'll stand over there, I'll film your reach track. You've forgotten one thing, my friend. I've got a legally binding signed contract here requiring you to perform the services as prompt. I need to have that bricked up.
Like a virgin, hey, touch for the very first time. Like a virgin, with your heartbeat next to mine.
Hi, thanks for coming to our campus support group for virgins. I'm Nitz Walsh, and this is Cal Evans.
Hi, Cal!
You're so fine, and you're mine. I'll be yours till the end of time, 'cause you made me feel. Yeah, you made me feel.
Come in.
Hi, Nitz. Got a minute?
Not really. I'm kind of busy.
I just wanted to talk about the health center the other day. I saw you run out and...
I was late for church, that's all. I was late for church and you were picking up a kilo of condoms. There's nothing more to talk about.
Nitz, I work part-time at the health center. Part of my job is to coordinate safe sex presentations with the dorm RAs and advise students on their sexual choices. That's what I was picking up the condoms for.
Blah.
When I saw you run out of the center, I got the feeling that you were embarrassed, and you totally shouldn't be.
Blah?
No. That's why I'm here, to set the record straight. Ooh. Because when two responsible, caring people make love, it can be one of the most totally amazing experiences ever. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Blah.
Look, I know this is a lot of information to process all at once, and that's okay.
Blah?
And don't feel badly. Most guys early on in their sexual lives don't even know how to properly put on a condom. Here, let me show you. Always start from the tip and gently massage the condom down.
Hey, buddy guy!
What happened? Where's Kimmy?
Yeah, she left. Nice ass.
Guys, I've got big news. Kimmy Burton came to my room and told me she wants to have sex with me.
Yay! Wait, I mean boo!
Yeah, I think you hit your head a little too hard.
It's true. She sat right here and showed me how to properly put on a condom. Where's the banana?
I ate it.
There was a condom on it. But it does seem a little weird, doesn't it? I mean, a few months ago, Kimmy didn't even know my name. Now she suddenly wants to have sex with me?
Because you were being extra virginal. It made her realize she loves you.
That is so stupid. You think a girl wants to sleep with him because he's acting all sensitive and hugging puppies and wanting to talk about feelings?
Oh my god! I love hugging puppies too! Hey, aren't you that creepy guy from those date rape skits?
Being extra virginal. Being extra virginal.
Shut up, Cal's voice in my head.
Okay, sorry, guy.
Hi, I'm Rocco, and sensitivity training is my life. Did I mention I'm a virgin?
Kimmy, hi, it's... Kimmy, hi, it's Nit. Kimmy, hi. Let's do it. Kimmy? Hey, it's Nitz.
I'm glad you called. I've been thinking about you. How you feeling?
Fine. Sorry for passing out the other day. I was just really tired.
Yeah, I know that feeling.
So I've been thinking about what you were saying, and I think I'm ready.
Great. Want to get together this weekend?
So soon?
I'm working at the health center, so why don't you just come by there?
The health center? Okay. I guess that's good. See you then. Holy crap. There is love in
So I told her it was the best apple brown Betty I ever tasted and gave her a daisy I grew in my garden.
Oh my God, Rocco, that is so sweet. I so admire a guy who's close to his mother.
And Kimmy wants to meet at the health center this weekend, so quick, Cal, tell me how to seduce a woman.
Sorry, guy, no can do. I'm a virgin now. I can't have sex until I get married, because I don't want to burn in hell.
Dude, whatever you do, just don't be yourself. It's totally working for me. Gotta pick up my bitch for another date.
Nitz, I'm sending you an audio file of a Chris Carter interview on NPR, where he explicitly denies any carnal relationship between Mulder and Scully.
Sorry, Gimp. Gotta go. I gotta go find out about life, about women, about what makes them tick, their likes and dislikes, and how to make sweet, sweet love to them all night long.
The hell?
A brilliant sun, virgin sand that stretches for miles, and not another soul to bother you. Because there are a thousand ways the Marzouk Desert can kill you, and that's a deterrent.
Are you tough enough to drive a Tacoma?
There's a Wendy's classic hamburger that's perfect for you, made fresh right off the grill, so it's always hot and juicy. The classic hamburgers at Wendy's. It's better here.
Get instant money from H&R Block. The world's first way to walk in with your taxes and walk out with a loan check. Come into H&R Block.
We here at Office Depot know you don't have a lot of time to shop for office supplies, so we make it easy with special sections loaded with the absolute essentials. Ink and toner, paper, envelopes, memo pads, files, file folders, stickies, and pens, so you can get what you really need. Really fast.
Office Depot. What you need to know.
Andy Anderson from Composure Magazine.
A simple assignment.
How to lose a guy in 10 days.
Doing everything girls do wrong in relationships.
That was supposed to last 10 days.
And other girls dream that they'd be Ben's partner.
Is turning into something.
Can I see you tomorrow?
He loves you.
That could last.
You're beautiful.
A lifetime.
All's fair in love and war.
True.
Great answer.
How to lose a guy in 10 days. Rated PG-13. Special sneak preview Saturday. Check local.
How to get a life, how to take a life. Ah, here it is. How to seduce a woman.
How to seduce a woman? No way, man. You on the skunkweed? This isn't how you do it, bro.
Well, then how am I supposed to learn?
Chocolate trouble, sweet lady cane, fists of dynamite, lips of love, Sir Pencilot, and my personal favorite, Black Jackson, mother...
Don't you have tapes to rewind, Whitey?
Look at those ancient cave drawings. It's amazing how man, even in its most primitive state, will strive to leave his indelible mark on the world.
And that hairy chick, she's really stacked.
I suppose so. In a very Earth Mother giving birth to the entire race sort of way. Wow, Rocco, you are so deep! Do you want to buy some vanilla fudge and read poetry to each other?
Only if I can braid your hair afterwards.
Betsy, it's finally happened. I have met the guy I always dreamed I would meet at college. He's so caring and sensitive.
Watch your ass, chocolate.
Oh, what's the matter, Tyree? You not man enough to watch it for me? I got your number, Black Jackson.
Ding! Now serving 28, baby. And one size does fit all. I ain't never seen that slut in my life.
Well, maybe this'll refresh your memory, Sir Pimps-a-Lot.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that chocolate sauce is nothing but sweet-ass trouble.
Oh, yep.
Yeah, you can say that again.
Sure, brother. Uh-huh.
You got that right.
I'm so glad you felt like sitting outside today, Rocco. It's such a beautiful day, and, well, I started thinking about us.
Just, move right here.
These past few days have been wonderful. I feel so close to you. Even closer than I felt to Jonah the day he slapped me with that restraining order.
There she is. There's my ex.
She's pretty, guy.
Hal, get out of my head.
Rocco! It's not like you to be so... aggressive.
I can't help myself anymore because you're so, hot. Our first kiss. Now, here. I'm ready, Charity.
Who is the man that'll seduce all the women with his seduction plan?
Nips!
Who is the cat that'll be having Miss Kimmy all up on his jimmy?
Nips!
I won't let you do it, best pal guy. I won't let you throw away your life for sex.
Move upside and let the man go through.
Okay. Watch out for DVDs, guy.
Hey, Nitz, you made it. Things are crazy around here, so why don't we go somewhere with a little more privacy?
You've read my mind, baby. You have read my mind.
There's a 24-hour flu going around, and we've been swamped. What are you doing?
It's on repeat. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I wanna kiss you all over.
Nitz, are you feeling okay?
I don't feel half as good as you look.
Excuse me?
You heard me, woman. Don't try and fight this thing between us. You don't have to anymore. Kiss me, Kimmy Burton. Kiss me like I know you can.
Oh, Rocco. No, I can't. This is wrong.
Huh? What are you talking about?
You're so good and pure. It's wrong of me to force myself on you like this.
No, it isn't. Go ahead. Force.
Here you are, a sweet, innocent virgin, and I'm practically accosting you.
No, you're not. I'm not even a virgin.
What?
I just said that to get into your pants.
How could you? You pig!
Rocco, just as I expected. Oh. My. God. Nitz, that was totally perfect. You're, like, amazing.
I am?
I had no idea you were so good. I can't wait to tell the RA group we've got our new date rape actor. Thank you so much. Imagine that. Two people actually having sex in the health center. How silly.
Your test results are in, Mr. Evans. You're clean. 100% disease-free.
Whew. Thanks, nurse lady. Thanks a whole bunch.
All in all, I'm pretty happy with the way things turned out.
What are you talking about? You didn't get laid. You didn't even get close. You sucked almost as badly as I suck.
Yeah, but it's a step in the right direction. And a kiss on the cheek from Kimmy Burton is worth 1,000 nights in the sack with any other girl.
Even...
Yes, Cal. Even Rosie O'Donnell.
After days of researching, cross-referencing, being in the most hardcore of hardcore chat rooms, seeing things no man should ever see, I have proven that Mulder and Scully never slept together. Not before, not during, not after any of the X-Files episodes or movies.
Well, what about in that episode where Fox hooks up with Scully on that ocean liner in that alternate dimension?
Alternate dimensions don't count! All I have to say is, girl, you mean so much to me.
Dad, where were you?
I've been outside. I walked around the park twice.
You went for a walk? Don't lie, Dad.
No, I'm not lying. I took a walk into the park and it felt great. You know the runner's high? I forget what, I don't know what they call it.
The runner's high?
Yeah. Let me sit down for a second.
Dizzy?
Oh, man, I got it.
You don't look well, Dad. Actually, you look a little peaked.
What you're seeing as peaked is just it's a healthy glow. I walked over 2.5 miles, Ben, at a brisk pace. Mm. I'm going to try to do this every day.
It's amazing how when you get old, that walking becomes a hobby.
It's pathetic, huh?
Yeah. Like you actually can take the stuff that used to be just necessities, like chewing and swallowing.
Hobbies.
All hobbies.
You know, while I was out walking, I passed by the municipal gardens. You know the little gardens on Jones Street? It was actually exciting to see what people are doing there.
I mean, those little gardens?
Yeah.
I mean, I've seen people garden there, and I'm not quite sure it's exciting, but I've seen it.
Well, the idea of making something from nothing is what's exciting about it.
Dad, you've seen those gardens 100 times. Why now?
6 weeks ago, even, it was just dirt. And now it's still dirt, but there's things peeking their heads out.
One walk.
You know what, Ben? I think I'm going to try that. I think I'm going to do it. I'm going to try and rent my own plot.
You're going to get one of those plots and gardening.
Ben, you think I'm joking about this, but I'm actually going to do this. Having some rhythm in your life and having some sense of continuity is an important thing.
So you think it'll be a healthy hobby for you now?
I'm not just talking about what it means to me. It's also, it's for you I'm doing this because these things are going to grow and hopefully someday you'll take an interest in them.
Like, what do you plan on planting?
You like veal? Hey, Laura.
Yeah?
Do you know anything about gardening?
Not really.
I'll tell you why I'm asking, because you know the city gardens where you can rent space?
Yeah.
I was actually thinking about getting a little plot and
really?
Oh, yeah. I actually am going to go do it, Laura. I really am. I'm looking forward to it.
Dr. Katz, I just can't imagine you, like, digging in the dirt on your hands and knees.
No shirt? Does that help?
No, I really...
Tank top?
No.
Pasties?
Ew.
Hi, my name is Mitch Hedberg. I'm coming in to see the doctor at 11 o'clock appointment.
I'm sorry, what?
I mumble a lot. Did you hear anything I just said? I don't own a cell phone or a pager. I just hang around everyone I know all the time. If someone needs to get a hold of me, they just say Mitch. And I say what? And turn my head slightly. I used to be a hot tower roofer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember that day.
Hmm.
I bought a donut, and they gave me a receipt for the donut.
Right.
I don't need a receipt for a donut, man. I give you the money, you give me the donut, and the transaction. We don't need to bring ink and paper into this. I just cannot imagine a scenario where I would have to prove that I bought a donut. Some skeptical friend... Don't even act like I didn't get that donut, man. I got the documentation right here. You know, on a traffic light, green means go and yellow means yield.
Mm-hmm.
But on a banana, it's just the opposite.
Right.
Green means hold on. And yellow means go ahead.
Right.
And red means where did you get that banana?
Hmm.
I opened up a yogurt and underneath the lid, it said, please try again. Because they were having a contest I was unaware of. But I thought I might have opened the yogurt wrong. Or maybe Yoplait was trying to inspire me. Come on, Mitch, don't give up. Please try again. A message of inspiration from your friends at Yoplait. Fruit on the bottom, hope on top. I eat a lot of sandwiches, and sometimes I don't want a sandwich. And that's when I realize everything's a sandwich. Like I ordered a salad, and they brought me a plate with lettuce, cheese, bacon bits, and croutons. It's a sandwich, some assembly required. You know when you go to a restaurant on the weekends, it gets busy, so they got to start a waiting list?
Mm-hmm.
They start calling out names. They say, like, Dufresne, party of two. Table ready for Dufresne, party of two.
Right.
And if no one answers, they'll say the name again. Dufresne, party of two. But then if no one answers, they'll just go right on to the next name. Bush, party of three. Yeah, but what happened to the Dufresnes? No one seems to care. Who can eat at a time like this? People are missing. You people are selfish. The Dufresnes are in someone's trunk right now with duct tape over their mouth, and they're hungry.
What's up, ladies?
The man who was born to party.
It's a poker convention.
Meets the city born to rock.
Cleveland, a friendly town.
On an all-new Insomniac with Dave Attell.
It's like a Hawaiian vacation.
Tomorrow at 10, only on Comedy Central.
Where's my thing?
Hey, here's Bob, the host with the most, you might say. And here's his buddy, Tom. Looks like Tom could use a little help. So Bob did the buddy thing and told Tom to call and order Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. Well, Tom got his Enzyte, and look at him now. Yes, in just a few short weeks, he's stepping large and laughing easy. Enzyte is not available in stores. Try now for only $29.95 per month. Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. This is Bob. Bob is looking cool. And with a call to Enzyte about natural male enhancement, Bob is living large. In a few short weeks, Bob has a big new spring of confidence, a generous swelling of pride, and the one thing every man deserves, a little well-earned respect from the neighborhood. Enzyte is not available in stores. Try now for only $29.95 per month. Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement.
This is Dave. This is his show. This is your warning.
Steve! What'd I say about him so hard, man?
Chappelle's Show, a new brand of comedy. Starts Wednesday, January 22nd at 10:30, only on Comedy Central.
Hey, Ben, guess what? I'll give you a hint.
Okay.
I'm on the waiting list.
You're on the waiting list.
For the gardens, Ben.
You're on the waiting list.
Yeah.
Congratulations. How long did they say you might have to wait?
Well, it could be anywhere from 6 weeks to 3 years.
Well, I'm very happy, actually, that you're on, because I have some good news, too.
No, what's that?
Well?
I bought you a whole bunch of gardening equipment over at the garden supply shop.
Oh, great.
Great. What'd you get?
Well, I just got you, you know, sort of the standard stuff. I got you a garden bag.
Mm-hmm.
I got you some small garden shovels of different sizes.
Mm-hmm.
I got you one of those, like, it's like a fork, a huge fork.
Oh, I know what you mean. It's like,
That tears up the,
The dirt.
The dirt.
Yeah. You didn't get me any dirt, did you?
I got you, fertilizer.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll tell you, fertilizer stinks.
Doesn't it say that right on the bag?
I was wondering if you do get a garden plot, whether I can be the guy who flies by and sprays it with insecticide.
You could be if you had a plane.
It would be very hard.
Well, you rent
one.
And
a pilot's license. And
some insecticide.
Well, that's easy enough.
Well, I'll make some calls.
Matt Siegel, here to see Dr. Katz.
Could you have a seat, please?
Okay. You know, I'm recently divorced, and I'm in a lot of pain.
Yeah, I heard.
What do you mean you heard?
Well, you talked about it on the air.
I did?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
But have you been in therapy before?
There was a time in my life when I was self-medicating, Doctor.
Right.
Does that count?
No. Matt, what is the name of your radio show, by the way?
Well, we call it Maddie in the Morning. It sounds infantile, doesn't it?
Well,
it really does. It sounds like a show, a baby show. It's awful.
I'm guessing you were probably the guy who picked that name.
This isn't good.
Am I right?
Do you ever help any of your patients?
You know, it's okay to take a swipe at yourself without taking one at me.
I know. I'm sorry. That's another problem I have. I find that I'm spiteful and vengeful.
You want to bring everyone down with you?
Can I?
Dr. Katz's office.
It's Ben, Laura.
I know.
Laura?
Yeah?
Have you talked to my dad today?
Well, yeah.
Well, you know his new thing, that he has a new hobby, which is he wants to get a plot at the Common Gardens and...
Right.
And, like, you know...
Right, gardening. What's wrong with that?
Well, I just think it's a dumb thing. I told him it's not a typical hobby for an older man, you know?
Well, actually, it is.
It is?
It's probably the most typical hobby for an older man.
Gardening is.
Well, yeah.
You're serious?
Yeah.
I think it's more of an older woman's hobby.
Oh, well...
If you want to go see older men, you go to the Turkish baths. That's more of a hobby for older men.
I'll try to remember that.
Matt, last week you were telling me how you feel somehow that your connection with your listening audience has deteriorated over the years. Is that correct?
Well, it seems as though the people that I meet that are bright and insightful don't care for me very much.
Right.
And yet I'm very popular with the dullards.
Well, let's try an experiment here, Matt. This might help, I don't know. It seems to me like you're holding so much in right now, so much anger. This is sort of the psychotherapy equivalent of the Heimlich maneuver. If you stand up for 1 second, let me just push on this area. You're right here.
I guess it did seem a little odd, all of a sudden, gardening.
Exactly.
I mean, how do you come up with gardening all of a sudden? I'm thinking something odd, something curious.
Huh.
So then I go down to the plot to check it out, right?
Yeah.
And aha!
What?
Aha! Laura, Watson, I can hear you.
What, Ben?
Mm-hmm.
Spill it.
Livingston, I presume. Huh?
Ben?
Yes, Laura.
What?
All right, well, I go down there, right?
Yeah.
And shazam!
But I go down to the plot, right?
Yes, and...
to the public gardens by Jones Street.
And
I go check out the plot he was looking at.
Right.
And right at the plot next to the one he's looking at, Greta.
Who's Greta?
An older, very distinguished-looking Scandinavian woman.
Yeah.
Apparently divorced, blonde hair, very attractive, leggy.
Oh.
So I realized that it had nothing to do with gardening. My dad just wants to meet a woman.
Well, I mean, what's wrong with that? That's kind of sweet.
Ridiculous, Laura. You don't go to a public garden to meet a woman.
Well, where else are you going to go?
Well, you don't know where she's been.
Oh, she's been in the garden.
Look, it's just no way to meet somebody. I would have done it differently.
Well, Ben, I don't really think that you're one to be giving advice on how to meet women.
Well, you know.
In fact, I think that it's a great idea. I mean, kind of sweet and romantic for somebody to be willing to look foolish just to get to know a woman that they might be interested in.
So you'd be charmed by, like, if somebody, you know the people who tuck in their shirt and then zip up after, and there's a little bit of shirt hanging out of the zipper. That's charming, right?
Well, it can be.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. So what? Flatulence. Also charming, right?
Matt, I think your perception of your listening audience is skewed towards the people who actually call.
So you're telling me that the people who don't even have the strength or the wherewithal to dial the phone are the actual core audience?
I think somebody who calls in to talk to a radio personality is somebody who is very needy and somebody who wants to be the show. They don't want to hear the show.
Why are you fixated on who calls radio stations? I come here in personal pain. I mean, are you fascinated with my profession, doctor?
Not fascinated. It's an interesting choice you've made.
It's a lonely life, you know. You sit in a little room and you talk to no one.
You talking about now?
There are parallels, I have
to say. Yes, it's true.
This is a special show.
Dave finally meets his match.
You got a job, Dave.
In the man with the ultimate late night job.
You're caught in the rat trap.
On an all-new Insomniac with Dave Attell.
Neil!
Thursday at 10, only on Comedy Central.
Beautiful.
The Kia Spectra. It's about freedom.
It's about dependability.
It's about independence.
Actually, it's about getting up to $2,000 cash back or 0% financing. Plus, every 2003 Spectra comes available with power everything, air conditioning, CD stereo, and a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty.
It's about peace of mind.
Oh, stop it. Now get a new Spectra and up to $2,000 cash back or 0% financing.
What do I taste in Banana Nut Crunch cereal? Grandma's recipe for banana nut bread. Believe me, I never needed an alarm clock on Sunday mornings. Banana Nut Crunch. It's one of the Post Selects.
When my family loves what we're eating, we talk about it.
This is new. What's it called?
Castellina.
Smoked cheeses. Give the sausage a great flavor.
I love the way they have the sun-dried tomatoes right in the sauce. It's so good.
Just a little wine. Delicious.
$8.95. That's a great price.
Chicken's so tender.
Try the mushroom. Nice and fresh.
I always say, you want to cook Italian? You got to cook bread.
And I always say, you want to cook? Be my guest.
Olive Garden. When you're here, you're family.
Choose your own way. Introducing Kick from Singular, the prepaid option that lets you choose your phone and your features. Phones start as low as $69.99 with $40 of airtime.
Get instant money from H&R Block, the world's first way to walk in with your taxes
and walk out with a loan check. Come into H&R Block.
Inventors, do you have an idea for a new product or invention but don't know what to do next? Are you interested in trying to submit your idea to companies and in applying for a patent?
I was in my workshop when I got an idea for a new invention.
The Invention Submission Corporation has free information to help you get started. ISC is America's largest inventor service firm. Call the toll-free number now to see how to get this information. The information includes materials that explain how to submit your idea to companies through ISC's data bank and how to apply for a patent. The Invention Submission Corporation even offers a virtual invention prototype service to present your idea to industry. Even if you only have an idea for improving an existing product, you'll want to call now for ISC's free information.
I'm calling ISC today.
Meet Michael.
Hi, my name is Michael Essany.
I'm still doing the show out here in Valparaiso.
He presents The Michael Essany Show, the new reality series following a regular guy with a simple goal, to become the next king of late-night television. But when the kitchen's your green room...
I'm sorry, I'm talking with my mouth full on camera.
...and your parents are the crew, you need to work a little harder to make your dream come true.
Mom, David Brenner's coming out.
The Michael Essany Show.
I'm actually a little bit nervous.
Coming in March.
Pre-show jitters.
Dad, where you been?
I was at the garden.
I figured. Were you in somebody else's garden?
Well, some of the people there, you know, it's actually a really nice group of people, and some of them are showing me a couple of gardening tricks.
Really?
Yep. And
were a whole bunch of people showing you, or just one person in particular?
Well, no one in particular. You know, it's a community of gardeners.
Right.
Yeah.
Was Greta there?
Yeah, she was there.
Really?
How do you know Greta?
Well, let's just say I was at the gardens today, too, Dad. And I met Greta.
Why were you snooping around the garden?
I wasn't snooping.
And what did she say about me?
What do you mean? Why Greta. Are you so interested?
Well, because, you know, I don't know.
Dad.
No, you said you met Greta.
Dad, the jig is up. I know what's going on. I know you like Greta.
She's a perfectly nice person. Why shouldn't I like her?
Dad, I guess I'm just proud of the old man, you know? You're going out of your way to meet a woman. It's very chivalrous.
I'm not going out of my way. I am gardening, and among my friends at the gardens is a woman named Greta, who I find very good company, that's all.
Mm.
These people are very genuine, very warm, and...
So how did it go with Greta today, did you?
Pretty damn good.
There's got to be an easier way to meet women.
I think I've come onto something with this gardening. I mean, it's not why I'm doing it. I'm not doing it to meet women, but...
I mean, it just seems so silly. It makes everything look so silly, like you're actually going to go garden just to meet that woman, Greta.
Yeah.
It's funny.
Well, have you ever seen a square dance? That's crazy, too.
You're not going to do that, are you?
No.
People in the parade are cocky, you know? They think that they have attracted an audience, but really it's just people waiting to cross the street.
Right.
I could attract a crowd, too, if I stood in everybody's way. I got into an argument with a girlfriend inside of a tent. That's a bad place for an argument, because then I tried to walk out and slam the flap.
That's tough.
How are you supposed to express your anger in this situation? Zipper it up really quick. I was standing by the door, and a security guard came over. He said, "You're going to have to move. You're blocking the fire exit." As though if there was a fire, I wasn't going to run. If you're flammable and have legs, you are never blocking a fire exit.
Right.
I like an escalator, man, because an escalator can never break down. It can only become stairs.
Right.
There'd be no sign that says escalator temporarily out of order, just a sign that says escalator temporarily stairs. I was working at the Riviera Hotel in Las Vegas, and there was four comedians on the bill, and we all had similar hair because we were all using the Riviera in-house shampoo.
Right.
It's two-in-one shampoo, and two-in-one is a bad term because one is not big enough to hold two. That's why two was created. If it was two-in-one, it would be overflowing. I think foosball is a combination of soccer and shish kebabs. Foosball ruined my perception of soccer. I thought you had to kick the ball and then spin round and round. I can't do a backflip. much less several, simultaneously with two other guys that look just like me.
There's something about planting seeds and coming back every day and seeing how they're doing. Mm. Nurturing.
Mm-hmm.
It's the getting out of the house, the sunshine, mm-hmm. the sense of community.
Come on, Katz, what's the catch here?
What do you mean catch? Why are you so suspicious all the time? You know, maybe Jonathan is just looking for a nice hobby.
Thank you, Julie.
Gardening is definitely something that can relieve stress, rejuvenate the soul. Right, Jonathan?
No, I mean, sort of. I mean, I'm doing it for relieving stress.
See?
But I also enjoy watching this particular woman digging up the dirt.
Jonathan!
In fact, I think that's the part that rejuvenates my soul.
I know it. You're doing it for a woman.
All right, so it's not about growing anything. You're just trying to get close to this woman.
Well,
and she has a gardening plot there.
Yeah, she has a plot. And, you know, she's been showing me a couple of tricks. Hadley here. He takes the seeds. She goes like this. Baby wants a new pair of shoes. Then she puts them in the ground. She said a lot of it's just luck.
Comedy Central is giving you a shot to co-host Insomniac with David Tell. If chosen, you'll be Dave's tour guide, checking out the sights and sounds of your fair city. Transportation provided by Orbitz.com. For complete rules and how to enter, go to ComedyCentral.com. Co-host with Dave is sponsored by Labatt Blue.
Geico.
Next, please.
Well, hello.
Oh, great. A talking gecko.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Customer satisfaction is at an all-time high. I don't think we've ever had numbers this high. Mm-hmm. I mean, this guy has really worked his tail off. His tail.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Get out of bed and get into Burger King. Start your day with a hot and delicious croissant sandwich for just 99 cents. Sizzling sausage, melted cheese, and egg on a flaky croissant. Just 99 cents for a limited time.
That's a break.
Today in local news.
Get your break going with the light, crispy, chocolatey taste of a Kit Kat.
His father was killed.
My sister followed a murderer to London.
And only one man can help him.
Let me see if I can get the facts straight. You have a sister?
Now, they're in a new world.
I want these men found.
They may not have a chance. But they do have each other. Jackie Chan, Owen Wilson.
I call that one my Kung Pao Chicken.
Shanghai Nights, rated PG-13. Sneak preview Saturday.
Tonight at 11, hate your neighbors? Imagine living next to this.
What is this noise you're hearing? Leaf blower, loud music?
Horrible explosions.
Stephen Colbert exposes America's noisiest neighbor. The Daily Show with Jon Stewart, tonight at 11, only on Comedy Central.
I mean, I can't even believe that you got one so soon.
Yeah, Ben, I feel like I just won the lottery. They called this afternoon and my number came up.
Well, I thought you said it was going to be 6 months to a year. Not...
Well, you know, I guess something happens to open up a plot, you know?
Somebody leaves or dies, and then one opens up. It's like an apartment.
I guess. Or other people drop off the list. You know, they just don't have the patience that I have.
So where is...
It's plot number 16, isn't it?
16.
Is that what it says?
It's right over here.
Wait a second.
This is your plot?
No, that can't be that plot, because that's Greta's plot.
That's right, I remember.
It's got to be some kind of mistake, Ben, because this is...
This is 16.
So...
Greta's apparently gone.
Yeah.
She must have left and moved out.
Well, she wouldn't have just moved out without saying goodbye.
Are you hurt by it?
Of course I'm hurt, Ben. I'm devastated.
Well, Dad, you know what? You could have... It might as well have happened this way. I think it was easier on you. Number one, you don't have to garden now.
True.
And, two, you know, you save yourself from getting hurt later.
We can't go through life afraid of being hurt, because that way you won't know love. You know, these relationships have a cumulative value. A little bit of love here, caring here, it adds up to nothing at the end of the day. You're home alone.
These are tough times for you.
Oh, man.
I don't know what you're going to do without all the walking and the gardening.
I was thinking about getting a cactus. What do you think about that idea?
Well, we certainly have the fertilizer.
Are you familiar with the Rorschach test?
I've never taken one. I know I'm familiar with the test.
Well, the idea is I'm just going to show you an image, and you tell me whatever pops into your head, and there's no right or wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to show you this, and tell me what's the first thing that pops into your head.
The Harvard-Yale game.
Huh. Now this one.
Harvard-Princeton.
What does this remind you of?
Well, it's a cave. Some kind of a cave. The Bat Cave.
That's right. Are you an only child?
No. Although, I don't really have much contact with my brothers and sisters.
But as a child, were you competing with them for the attention of your parents?
Well, I like to feel as though we all lost.
How many of you were there?
Three.
A brother and a sister.
Right.
Isn't it always like that?
Hmm.
Did you have a lot of friends when you were a kid?
Yeah. Interestingly, I'm friendly with a lot of my childhood friends.
You still maintain relationships with them?
Well, that's the good news.
Yeah.
The bad news, I don't seem to have made a new friend since I was 7 or 8 years old.
See, I don't know why that's bad news. It just says that you are a guy who is loyal.
Right.
Who likes to take things as far as they can go.
Mm-hmm.
And who can't make new friends.
I can't wait till this session is over, because I have a roll of lifesavers in my pocket, and pineapple is next.
That's great, Mitch.
This shirt is dry clean only,
mm-hmm.
which means it's dirty.
Hmm.
I wrote a script and I gave it to a guy who reads scripts, and he read it and he said he really likes it, but he thinks I need to rewrite it. I said, forget that. I'll just make a copy. I'll go to Kinko's, because Kinko's is my favorite copy center if I had to pick one.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're open 24 hours.
Right.
That's great. Like if it's 5 a.m. and then I decide I need two of something. Sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night in a cold sweat. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Kinko's. No problem. See, I'm a dreamer, man. And when I was a cook, I'd always work with people who weren't dreamers. Like, mm-hmm. I was cooking at this restaurant, and I put a hot dog on the grill, and my kitchen manager came over. He said, Mitch, put the hot dog up here in the right-hand corner of the grill, so in case you get a whole bunch of orders at once, you have all this space available.
Right.
See, that's how I knew he wasn't a dreamer, because the day I give up my dreams is the day I have strategic grill locations.
Hmm.
A dreamer has a philosophy. The entire grill is hot.
Whoops. You know what the music means, but we're gonna have to stop. Our time is up.
Well, okay, that's cool. I got that lifesaver waiting for me, man. You know, you want one? You can have the one after the pineapple, which would probably be cherry, which is everybody's favorite.
Well, I don't know if it's everybody's favorite.
Ah, oh, see, man, you look at things too deeply. Come on. Cherry's good.
Thank you.
On Chappelle's Show, Dave sure knows what women want to hear.
You have great New York boobs. They rest on my arm like an eagle on a perch.
See what everyone's talking about. Chappelle's Show, new episode Wednesday at 10:30, only on Comedy Central.
It was amazing.
And covered in this thick, dark stuff.
Look, that's it, that's it.
No, this had chips.
Chips Ahoy cookie bars, stuffed with chocolate cream, drenched in fudge, unlike anything you've ever experienced. They're beyond belief.
Let's say one phone company provides you long distance and a completely different one has your local service. Now, you probably pay too much for both of them, but you let it slide until you discover that with the neighborhood, you can get unlimited local and long distance together for one low monthly price. And just for good measure, extras like caller ID are included.
Call 1-800-JOIN-NCI today. The neighborhood, where local and long distance come together. Over a million have joined.
How about you?
Cooler than hell. Devil May Cry 2. Rated mature. Only from Capcom.
Let's rock, baby.
I'm singing in the rain. Just singing in the rain. I'm happy again.
Want over 200 channels with crystal clear reception even when it rains? You can't get that from satellite.
I'm singing and dancing in.
Time Warner Cable. Now anything's possible.
Slash interest rates, reduce payments, and get out of debt much faster with the Debt Relief Clearinghouse.
I had a couple of accounts go to 0%, some went to 6, some went to 9.
My payments were roughly around 500, and just here recently my payment has dropped down to 277.
It's a relief off my shoulders.
I'm out of debt. I can breathe easier.
I finally have control over my debt.
Call the number on your screen to dramatically lower your interest rates and get out of debt. Call the Debt Relief Clearinghouse now.
Ah, home at last. Worn down and weary after a hard day's work. But a remedy awaits, for tonight is my night to pamper myself. And I don't mean the diapers, which are penciled in for Wednesday. A night made in heaven, and who deserves it more than I? Toiling tirelessly yet another day in order to provide food and clothing for my family. All right, clothing.
Bye, Dad. Though we're only 10 years old, we're going out to find a job because we haven't had pants that fit us in 3 years.
All right, neither. I hate that. I walk around minding my own business, talking to myself, and suddenly everything I say becomes a setup for some perfectly timed joke at my expense.
Unfortunately, I didn't hear you or I would have made a joke at your expense.
See?
Duckman, I've got a job for you to do.
Unless it involves you, flammable pajamas, and a wayward pilot light, I have other plans. Tonight, the Chateau Duckman is my castle, and I am king.
You mean Rodney King? Or Don King. Oop, I have to go to the gym. Maybe when I get back, we can do Larry, Perry, and Coretta Scott.
Go quickly and go far, oh nagging spawn of Satan. I, in the meantime, will find solace in the intellectual challenge that is cable TV. Wow, he fishes while he talks.
My bus driver wanted to make sure I got home. Dodd, given that Aunt Bernice doesn't have the time lately to ask me to repeat what I said after her blank look, and given that the twins are each lucky enough to have a second head to converse with, I was thinking perhaps I could talk to you.
That's fine, son. It's good to have a dream.
But Dodd, I think this might be that time in an adolescent's development when he needs to, you know, discuss things with his father.
Are you trying to tell me this is the Big P?
I thought we had that penciled in for Wednesday.
Puberty, Ajax? Are you getting bigger pimples? Sporting a little peach fuzz on the bill? Feeling repulsed by your own scrawny appearance? Mercilessly laughed at by girls despite a deepening desire to be close to them? Suddenly aware of a fire in your loins engulfing you in a living inferno? Sending you off behind a closed door for up to 3 to 4 weeks at a time?
No.
Me neither. So, we've bonded. I've grown. Now, don't you have some earwax to sculpt or something?
If you're not in the mood to talk, we could just watch TV together.
The Father-Son Hour.
Quality time with your teenage son.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Every son needs a father.
Nope.
Naked women giving Vegas odds.
Woo-hoo-hoo! And will you take a look at the spread? Ajax, I feel it's my duty as a responsible parent to make you leave the house tonight. Here's a buck and a half. If you're buying beer, you'll have to panhandle for the rest.
Okay, Todd. I'll wander the streets, picking up my morals, values, and core beliefs from the people of the night. Then come back when I'm fully formed and beyond your influence.
Good boy. Oh, wait, I can help. Remember that movie where the dad learns he's dying from a fatal disease, so he makes a tape telling his child everything he thinks it's important to know? Well, I have one for you.
Are you dying from a fatal disease?
Nah, I just knew I'd be watching a lot of TV.
I wasn't asking a lot. It's just that as I grow, I find myself experiencing changes. Granted, less extreme ones than I felt after swallowing the Drano, but changes I'd like to discuss with someone. Ow!
I'm Tommy Lee Grebsnig, and this here's Billy Saw Mobbinrib. We're inferior beings from the planet Betamax.
We come looking for the wisest man on Earth so's he can bring progress to our real pearly but backward and full of stupid people planet. Might antisocial. Nice body, though.
Greetings, furrowed fellows. What planet are you from?
You hear that, Billy Saw? He knows we're from somewheres else. Wee doggies, Tommy Lee. He must be the wise one.
Actually, my name is Ajax, not to be confused with the man on TV who fixes bicycles. But you probably wouldn't, because his name is Bill.
Whoosh! Went right over my head. I'm Tommy Lee, and this here's Billy Saul. We got the same voice on account of all us beings from Betamax never had an original thought in our heads, so we copy everything we can.
That, plus thousands of years of sleeping with our relatives.
Well, there's nothing like a close family.
A profundity. Hoo-wee! He's the one, Billy Saul. Somehow we gotta trick him into getting on board our ship. You ever seen the inside of a spaceship?
No.
One, two?
Okay.
Claimed not to know it was a gay bar.
Shut up, you old whore!
Ajax brand Euro coffee. A-J-A-X. Ajax!
That explains why there's no puddles of drool next to the dog's bowl! Ajax is missing! Boys, check the house and the yard! Listen up, Daffy Duh! I don't know what's happened to Ajax, but I've got a feeling you're responsible.
I've never been the least bit responsible, and you know it. Besides, it could be lots of places.
He's not here. But don't worry, Dad. There's no reason to believe that Ajax won't safely lumber into the open arms of home, hearth, and family.
Unless, of course, he was callously and selfishly rejected by you, sending him into the open arms of white slavers, the Alpha Ta, or people who appreciate the photographs of Robert Mablethorpe.
Hey, cats and kittens.
Corny, what have I done?
Compared to Mozart, not a hell of a lot.
I can't take the guilt!
For posing as a blind shower repairman at the girls' lacrosse finals, for using your great-aunt's ashes for carpet deodorizer, for getting change for your Monopoly money from a UNICEF box.
What are you, my biographer? All right, look, everyone, he hasn't been gone that long. How bad a situation could he have really gotten into?
I told you we should have got insurance when we rented this. Hot dog, Ajax! Ooh. Welcome to the planet Betamax!
You dropped a 5-credit note. Why, so I have. Let me repay you for your loss. Do you have change for a 10? I don't, but take a 20. Thank you. Don't mention it.
Billisol, Tumalee, what y'all think you're doing?
We don't think nothing. We're just doing whatever Ajax does. Ernest T., this is Ajax. Ajax, Ernest T. Glob. Ernest T. here sounds a little bit different from everyone else, so we made him deputy.
It's me, the deputy.
Ajax is the one we've been looking for. He's kind and gentle and wise. And he can sing.
We're looking for a clue that could lead us to him. Anything you don't ordinarily see in Ajax's room. Duckman. Duckman.
I found these disgusting things in Ajax's closet. Why didn't I teach him to just say no to this garbage?
This is Ajax's room. That stuff is from your closet.
Oh. Hey, I didn't know he could sculpt clay.
Not clay. Cheese. Each sculpture corresponds to the cheese used. For example, this goat is made from goat cheese. This map of Switzerland is made from Swiss cheese.
What's his head made out of?
Ugh.
My money for college. I didn't know Ajax wanted to go to college.
I didn't know he could spell college.
Well, actually.
Look at college with two L's.
It's only later that the six Q's sneak up on you.
No money inside, just papers. I owe me $28, Dad's racetrack night. I owe me $16, Dad's bondage, bowling night. Oh, there's dozens of these.
Apparently, Ajax has been sneaking money into your wallet.
This has got to be $300-$400, every allowance he ever got. Doesn't he spend any money to make himself happy?
This probably did make him happy. Well, there's a couple of leads here we can follow. With the whole family helping, we can cover a lot of ground before dark. Think we missed anything?
Just my son's whole life.
We all got your general store. You got your traffic light. You got your scaly flying glibneasers that drop your oogla everywhere.
Interesting tour, Ernest T., though I'm sure the ability to comprehend and recall would have greatly enhanced my enjoyment.
So tell us about your planet. What's that like?
Well, let me think. I know that it spins really fast.
Give us the word!
Tell us
what it's like and take off!
Get up on that there mount so everybody can see on you.
You all really want to hear what I have to say? To start. Well, always burp the air out of the white bread before you put the twist tie on. And blessed are the pacemakers, though without them we'd inherit things a lot sooner. And cherish the occasions when you don't have to shower, cause men's odor is what makes men's men feel like men's men, men, men.
Ah, men!
Wow, it's as if I found a whole new family, one that really wants me around. I think I'll stay.
If you click on it, he will come.
Hi, I'm Dave Chappelle. Help keep my brother off the street. Go to ComedyCentral.com and check out the Chappelle Show website.
Dynamite!
Go behind the scenes with Dave at ComedyCentral.com.
Ha!
I've called this meeting this morning to discuss the meeting this afternoon.
I'd like to have a meeting after this meeting to discuss what we met about.
Let's have a pre-meeting for that.
I'll bring the Dream Donut.
Oh, I'd like to be in on that meeting.
The new Dream Donut, only at 7-Eleven. And yeah, they're that good.
Mm. I like meetings.
Rocket to me!
If someone wrote a book about your life, would anyone want to read it? Maybe.
Accelerate your life.
Presenting the new 12-inch PowerBook, the world's most compact, full-featured notebook computer. And the new 17-inch PowerBook, the world's first and only 17-inch notebook computer. The new 12 and 17-inch PowerBooks. The next big and small things from Apple.
Something for women that's more secure than an email password. Kotex brings you readjustable wings with strips by Velcro USA. Kotex fits. Period.
We're talking spin-off with the animators. There's some feelers from DreamWorks. We're big fans, that kind of thing. You?
Summer tour came through. Odd Couple. Felix this time. I wanted to stretch. Dinner theaters mostly, but classy, you know? 2-drink minimum.
I'm doing time and temperature for Southwest Bell.
Aha.
Very nice.
Good gig.
Real challenge.
Okay, kids. We're ready.
Speed.
Nice energy. And action.
We gotta find Ajax. But how are we gonna know where to look?
Of course, I'm not a professional detective. I don't really understand these complex matters, but maybe you should look into places he usually goes!
Okay, maybe. But I have no idea where he goes. If only there were people who really knew him. People near his age who lived with him. People who were like brothers to him. What? What?
We're his brothers.
Oh, well, aren't we special? We're his brothers. Ooh, look at us. We're so important. We're his brothers. Look, boys, does our little interruption have anything whatsoever to do with the problem we're trying to solve?
You know the drill. Slowly, with as many little words as possible.
We made up a list of his favorite places to go, Dad. They might surprise you. If indeed you're still surprised by the fact that you know almost nothing at all about the members of your own family.
I'll have you know, Mr. Smarty Pants, that that doesn't surprise me one bit. Once again, I emerge with the upper hand. I don't get it, Corny. Why would he come here? There's nothing but art.
Perhaps he was looking to compensate for something he found lacking in his home environment.
You're right. They've got full frontal nudity. Woohoo!
Sad, isn't it? Some kid comes in here every day to look at that statue, walks back and forth so much he's worn down the concrete.
Duckman, I think I've found something that may give us a clue as to what Ajax was looking for.
That'd be right there, Corny. Just seeing what she'd look like with both her breasts.
Duckman, are you sensing a pattern in the places Ajax likes to come?
Yeah, he's not at any of them. It's true. I don't know him, do I, Corny? I've let him grow up without bothering to find out who he is or what he wants. But now, if anything's happened to him, it's my fault. Because of me, he's out on his own, helpless and friendless and alone in a cold, cruel world.
Sometimes at night, if you leave your window open, the fumes from a nearby paint factory can help you get to sleep. By eating tainted food from dented cans, you can simulate the feeling of a gunshot wound to the stomach without actually being fired upon. Dot says if you give the asbestos inspector enough money, he won't bother you again for a whole year.
You up and mentioned some feller called Dodd. Is that who you learned from?
Dodd? Well, I guess he's the one who's most responsible for making me what I am.
Well, shut my mouth and call me a cab. This Dodd must be one humdinger of a superior creature. Got a picture? And
handsome sort, and you're the spitting image, except for the size and the shape and the color and the face and stuff.
He also made me this educational videotape wherein he talks about everything he felt it was important for me to know.
Sir-wee! Can we watch?
Sure. Do you have VCRs?
Handy, but repairs are a pain in the butt. We're backward, but we got our priorities. Listen up, everybody. It's Dodd, the varmint who's so wise, he taught Ajax everything he knows.
Whoa!
My advice is to write it all down. These are gonna be words to live by.
What the hell are you staring at?
And so it was that Dodd's wisdom was visited upon our world. He spoke to us of a new way of living, a new way of behaving toward one another. His way.
Remember, cheeks red, cleavage scrunched.
Dodd bless Betavax. We'll do it in the name of Dodd. And Dodd said unto us, if someone beat us the crap out of you, then you beat us the crap out of him.
I do love it here, but if all I'm going to see is mobs and guns and explosives, I might as well be back at school.
You remember how this dang thing works?
I believe that button takes us straight up.
Truly, he was the son of Dodd.
Nice shot, Timmy. This duck hole is a hard one.
I'm at a loss. What possible connection can there be between a family beach, a statue of a family playground and amusement park, a family picnic area, a family rec center, a restaurant with a weekly Families Eat Free night, a taping of the game show Family Feud, and a miniature golf course filled with families?
Sorry about that, Ajax.
I forgive you. You didn't know what you were doing. Dodd?
I've never been so happy to see anyone in my whole life!
Bail bondsman.
Okay, yeah, but this is good too. Where'd you go?
Actually, it's quite interesting. I was kidnapped by hillbilly aliens who all have the same voice, then taken to their planet and worshipped as a deity by millions until your videotape caused the entire culture to be enveloped in a downward spiral of violence, greed, and pornography.
I was like one clue away from guessing that.
I think you might have been dreaming, Ajax. You look like you had a nasty hit on the head. Are you okay?
Of course he is. And the important thing is that he's back with us. You being gone has taught me a valuable lesson, Ajax. It's that when a father and a son... The important thing about being... Help me out here.
I think you learned that too often we fail to take the time to really get to know those we love the most.
That was okay. Sometimes you do better.
Thanks, Don. It means a lot to hear someone else say you meant to say that. I learned a lesson, too. I went searching for a connection to a family who would love me and listen to me, and I found it amongst a planet full of people who felt I was worth more than any of you ever will. But, you know, I'm glad to be back and everything.
Come on, son. Let's go home.
Maybe the whole thing was a dream, Todd. After all, in real life, can you imagine a whole civilization worshipping a god who created the very world that plagues them?
Late Night with Conan O'Brien.
If Comedy Central were a cocktail party, I'd be a fancy bottle of champagne.
Cheers to last night's Late Night on Comedy Central. Late Night with Conan O'Brien. Weeknight
at 7.
Boom, boom, boom. Fred, the sooner you order that server, the sooner I can change my mind about it.
Can't talk now, Fred. Got a network to crash.
Don't kill yourself, Fred. We don't need those upgrades till tomorrow.
Hey, Fred, the computer says system failure. Is that bad?
Dealing with technology is hard. That's why CDW makes buying it as simple as possible, with a personal account manager who understands what you need and gets back to you quickly.
Fred, someday we'll look back on this server thing and laugh.
CDW, the right technology right away.
Ignoring everything else in his life, Chef Jimmy of Quiznos is total dedication in his pursuit of unrivaled bacon, mushrooms, mozzarella, and a creamy Alfredo sauce without equal. The ideal chicken carbonara sub is all Chef Jimmy thinks about. He's done it. Quiznos chicken carbonara sub.
Toasty.
Eres mi abeja, eres mi flor, eres mi tierra.
Oh, Dan.
It's Howard.
Oh, Howard.
Every day, Ameridad helps more people with money problems.
My credit card debt was outrageous. Then I called Ameridad. They contacted my creditors and got my payments almost cut in half.
Ameridad is a nonprofit organization that offers free consultations to consumers seeking to eliminate their debt.
Every month I pay our credit card bills, but the balances never seem to get smaller.
Ameridad got our interest rates reduced, and now the balances are dropping dramatically.
Call 1-800-698-4664. Ameridad, helping America get out of debt.
Introducing Physaderm Clear Swabs. Just snap to release the strongest acne medicine without a prescription. Then, zap. New Physaderm Clear Confidence Clear Swabs. Do you have confidence?
Makes men's men feel like men's men.
Mm-hmm.
This is Bob. Bob is playing well. That's because not long ago, Bob decided to go big time. New clothes, new clubs, and a call to Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. And in just a few short weeks, Bob has a big new swing of confidence, a little well-earned respect, and a very happy partner back at the clubhouse. Enzyte is not available in stores. Try now for only $29.95 per month. Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement.
I'm the one causing the trouble here.
The shocker comedy you've been waiting for. It's the underground comedy movie, available only through this special TV offer. Damn funny, say critics, and the single most offensive movie ever made.
Oh, not now, honey, not now.
With supermodels in the job, taking a with Gina Lee Nolan, Michael Clark Duncan, Slash, and Joey Buttafuoco. Music by NoFX, Guttermouth, and more. Composed of hardcore, brutal, in-your-face skits such as The Porno Review, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Donna of the Dead, Dickman Fights Lesbians. The censors won't allow us to show you how far this movie really goes. The underground comedy movie is guaranteed to offend your money back. Only $19.95. Order now and get a bonus video absolutely free. That's two videos for only $19.95. Can't charge it? No problem. Debit it. Also available on DVD. Don't wait. Call now to guarantee the bonus video. Call the number on your screen now. Must be 18.
Check it out. Introducing the all-new Ram Heavy Duty. Grab Dodge's new 7-year, 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it.
Would you like the power to change from this to this? Join the thousands of men and women who are changing their bodies and lives with our best-selling videos hosted by fitness celebrity John Basow.
Fitness Made Simple gives you the power to change. The power to change your body. The power to change your life.
Order our power package today and get the original Fitness Made Simple workout and nutrition video, plus AM/PM workouts, John's popular morning and evening exercise video for only $29.95. That's two videos for the price of one. Call now.
Fitness Made Simple, bringing real results to real people.
Cretin, liar, drunk, agent. Hello. And just in time for discipline hour.
You! Bumper car! You think you can go plowing into a law-abiding if I can beat the statute of limitations citizen just because you're too lazy to take off those sunglasses indoors? Hey, don't point that white cane at me! Great, now I missed them dressing her wounds.
Look, Mr. Duckman! We've alphabetized all your files!
We put all the cases you've solved in this folder.
And all your failures over here. Divided by type. Miserable failure, total failure, and what were they thinking even hiring you in the first place, failure?
My, my, how efficient. In fact, you've inspired me to do a little filing of my own. Well, I better head off. I love language. Every day, Corny, it's one little thing after another. The worm in your liverwurst. The spot of urine on your best tie. Now some yutz in the hall not watching where he's going. Sometimes I think I'm the only one who notices, who isn't totally oblivious to everything around him.
I'm not corn-fed.
Oh, right. The hat threw me.
I'm not wearing a hat.
That's what threw me.
Actually, Duckman, you should know who this is.
Of course I know who this is, trolling for truffles. It's that old crooner with the San Francisco song who did one of those unplugged albums and got popular again.
It's always a mistake to skip our morning briefings on who you know, where you live, and what you're currently under investigation for. This is Iggy Catalpa, the politically correct comedian who King Chicken used to try to drive you insane.
How come you always get the backstory?
How come you got a scene with Heather Locklear?
Duckman, you're the only one who can help me.
What?
You're the only one who can help me.
Come on, come on, speak English, will you?
I'm sorry, Mr. Catalpa. Duckman has never heard that particular combination of words before. What Iggy means is that he's not here to hurt you because of a bill you haven't paid.
Oh, really? Do go on.
I have uncovered irrefutable proof that right here in our own beloved city, there exists a shocking conspiracy. An evil conspiracy that encompasses the globe, yet is so cloaked in mystery as to befuddle the finest minds of our age. Which is not to belittle the many other minds of our age, which, while they may not be the finest, are nonetheless fine indeed.
Mr. Catalpa, what exactly is this conspiracy?
It's villainy incarnate. Every time I do my wash in the laundromat, I lose one sock.
Oh, man! Watch out! A sock! Oh, my aching piles! Stop!
One sock, huh? The bastards! If it's the last thing I do, I'll get to the bottom of this conspiracy! Well, how refreshing it is to... to have a client who appreciates the cost of doing business. But worry not, Mr. Catalpa. You can rest assured that in my relentless pursuit of the truth, I'll buy only what is absolutely necessary. Wally Bully! Wally Bully!
Duckman, since you've taken a case for apparently no other reason than to ruin the client's credit rating, the least you could do is...
Wally Bully!
I am taking wash and putting it into the dryer. Repeat, I am taking wash and putting it into the dryer.
I am taking my underpants and pulling them below my knees. Repeat, I am taking my underpants and pulling them below my knees.
While the odds of Iggy's conspiracy being true are roughly equivalent to the possibility of a Bob Dole Snoop Doggy Dog duet, how can you totally dismiss it without the slightest pretense of investigation?
Police, Chronicle, that guy's more paranoid than all those people who are trying to kill me.
Paranoia is vital to the economy, Duckman. It supports a cottage industry of books, movies, television shows, trade fairs, and, surveillance equipment.
Hey, name one thing I bought that wasn't essential for this case.
The closet full of Sansebelt Armanis, the Evian waterbed, the 350 pounds of Malamars, the surround sound CD system you listen to while checking out the Sheryl Crow album cover for visible panty lines.
I said one thing!
Someone is entering the laundromat. It's your family.
My family? Oh, right, the washer broke.
I can't explain it, boys. If I didn't know better, I'd say someone sat on top of the rotator blades with the lid open in some perverse act of sexual depravity.
Why do I get the sneaking suspicion that it has to do with that walking fiasco who tries to pass himself off as our father?
Except it's hard to believe Dad could sink any lower in his pathetic attempts to fulfill his grotesque and unspeakable physical needs.
I can't believe they say that behind my back.
It's what they say to your face.
I know. You'd think they'd at least change a word or two.
Well... there's one good thing you could say about Dodd.
What's that?
Perhaps one is the wrong number.
And to think this is the year I almost remembered his birthday and Christmas. Hey, where were you?
Outside helping that campfire girl den mother.
Okay, but next time let someone else sew her arm on. You're tracking blood on the mohair.
You know, Duckman, I...
Me! That's all you ever think about! What about me? I'm having a deep and personal family crisis here, and I need to talk to someone. All the real detective teams confide in each other. Holmes and Watson, Starsky and Hutch, Hart and, what was his wife's name?
I'm sorry, Duckman. I'll listen to your pain. What is it you were saying?
Oh, forgot. Gotta hit the crapper.
Yeah!
Hey, it's a documented medical condition! All right, let me through. Damn ninjas like roaches in this city. Lay off the hooch, Nightcrawler. I tell you, near-mythological Oriental martial arts warriors today got no self-respect.
No. Give me Iggy Catalpa's stolen sock.
No. Some detective investigating this conspiracy might see it and follow us.
Hey, would you mind?
Screw it.
Oh. Wow! Nothing like getting clubbed by a professional. You wake up clear-headed and refreshed. Not like with those sorority girls who think it's so funny to drop a concrete block on a guy who just spent 2 hours snaking a periscope through a shower drain. Hey, wait a minute. I've been kidnapped. Where have they taken me? Where could I be? Think. Think! What's my location? What could this place be? Ah! Roadmaps? What kind of clue is that? I need roadmaps like I need these lists of emergency roadside service phone numbers and all these applications for the auto club. All right, fashion victims. What the hell's...
It's open. Hi, Duckman. Hang on a sec. Yeah, Marty, I went gold down 3 at the morning fixing. I want the Mideast talks inconclusive. Right, same as usual. Back home, I want you to keep on that liberals control the media, conservative control the government thing, keeping in mind that both sides have worthwhile and valid points of view. I want Trudy Martin to break a heel outside her realty office at 3:46 p.m. And I want another sports strike. What's left? Okay, then, beach volleyball.
Iggy, what's going on?
It's a conspiracy. Thanks, Doc. Welcome to the World Domination League, the secret force behind every conspiracy. The death of Elvis, what really happened to Monroe, Hendrix, Morrison.
And President Kennedy?
No, actually that was a lone gunman. But everything else was us. The rise of communism, the fall of communism, getting prayers out of schools, getting sex on TV, the way pens don't work in the post office, the Olsen twins. You see, I'd been a failure my whole life. As a stand-up comic, a cardiovascular surgeon, a development exec for the Warner Brothers Network. Then I saw this ad, Evil Genius Fuller Part-Time. And I realized now more than ever we needed an evil genius kids could look up to. And all I have to do is destroy the moral and economic underpinnings of a once great nation. Ah! I asked a good friend of mine who was also an evil genius, and he agreed.
But why, Iggy? Why do this?
The same reason anyone like me would want to dominate the world. Terrific retirement package. Ooh, it's the Division of Poetic Irony. I love these guys. They gave Newt his gay half-sister. World domination, Iggy here. Beautiful, do it. A bunch of animal rights activists get eaten by bears. How do they come up with these things?
But then, this whole sock business, it was just a ruse.
No, a conspiracy. Thank you. It's just the way we do things around here. Everything's gotta be an elaborately woven plot. Plus, the WDL supports itself by selling those cute little sock puppets. So now we can silence the one detective who can stop us.
Well, thank you very much. And if you don't mind, I'll use that quote in my new press pack.
Get real. The only reason you're here is your friendship with the most brilliant mind the world has ever produced.
Charlie Rose? We're not friends. It was one night. I was drunk. Things got a little...
Corn-fed pig. He must die.
Corny? That second banana? He's nothing. I'm the brains of the outfit. I'm the one you should be assassinating. I'm the one you should be plotting to kill and maim and torture and... Well, no, he's a bright guy.
He gets... Take this stuff to brainwashing.
Room 101?
No, Lisa's in for touch-ups. Try 102.
Hey, wait a minute! Let go of me!
What?
Oh, nothing. I was just saying it because, you know, you were dragging me away.
What a putz.
Hey, stop that! Let go!
Just ignore him.
Hydrangeas, on the other hand, can grow quite large. They begin blooming in summer and continue until early winter if given the proper amount of mulch. Hydrangeas come in a variety of colors, white, pink, blue, world domination.
League, want to thank you for taking time from exploiting the global economy to be here today. The individual sitting to my left has been brainwashed to believe he is attending a rather dull yet informative lecture at the Ladies Floral Society.
If you were 30 years younger, I'd like to plant something in your mulch.
It became clear that this duck man would be the greatest brainwashing challenge we'd ever face when our test revealed that he didn't have enough brain to wash. We began clearing what we whimsically referred to as Duckman's mind by showing him 18 continuous hours of the Wayans brothers. Then, after gaining his trust through the use of a variety of rubber goods, it was time to turn him against the intended target. Subjects will often resist our reprogramming for weeks, months, even years.
Cornfed just pretends to be your friend to ruin your life.
Of course.
The members of your family are all agents of Cornfed, accepting millions of dollars in porcelain poker-playing dogs to pretend they despise you.
Why didn't I think of it before?
Your failures in life, women, career, women, family, women, they're all due to Cornfed.
It's the only logical explanation.
Next comes the introduction of the trigger, a signal which will instantly turn the subject into a superb killing machine. In this case, the playing card, Queen of Hearts. The results? Duckman?
Why don't you play a game of solitaire?
There, the look of emptiness that indicates the subject's mind has been completely drained.
Red on black or red on red? Jack's higher than a 10, right? Wonder how you cheated solitaire. Maybe if I distract me.
Excuse me a moment. We've also programmed an untrigger, a common everyday phrase sure to be used after the crime is committed. This will cause the subject to forget everything that's happened.
Call the police!
Gentlemen, I give you the perfect assassin, the most deadly killing machine in history, Duckman!
A Jack is higher than a 10!
Stay tuned for another episode of South Park, then cop a feel with the Man Show, only on Comedy Central.
Cooking pasta is easy, but when it's time to drain, it's a pain. Stop. Introducing Pasta Pot Express, the perfect all-in-one cook, strain, and drain pasta pot. Watch. Just cook your favorite pasta, lock on the Pasta Pot Express strain and strain lid, and in seconds you've strained and drained right through its built-in locking colander pot top. It's that simple. The Pasta Pot Super Nonstick Surface lets you make rigatoni and cheese that's sure to please. And since nothing sticks, clean up the freeze. And it's not just a pasta pot. Now you can brown a pot roast and drain the fat with ease. You can brown and drain chopped meat for the tastiest tacos ever. Watch. Preparing potatoes has never been easier. 5 pounds of carrots are cooked and drained right through the locking lid. There's no better way to cook pounds of pasta plus all your favorite dishes than with the Pasta Pot Express. Order your Cook, Drain, and Strain Pasta Pot Express with deluxe color recipe guide filled with delicious, easy recipes direct for only $14.99. Hold on to your phone. Order now and receive the personal size Pasta Pot Express with the locking straining lid plus the perfect pasta spoon, the perfect cheese grater, great soft cheese, hard cheese, absolutely anything you please. Plus, the amazing hand chopper that cuts prep time in half. This entire gift pack is free. Pay only shipping and handling. That's right. Order direct and get the Pasta Pot Express with the deluxe recipe guide. Order the Pasta Pot Express for only $14.99. Order now.
To order your Pasta Pot Express gift pack, have your credit card ready and call this toll-free number. Or send your check or money order to the address on your screen. You can also use your checking account just like a credit card. Just have your account number ready when you call. Pasta Pot Express is only $14.99 plus shipping and handling. For your convenience, to order online or to check out other fine products and special offers, check out our website at tvinventions.com.
Get fit with the Awesome Hour Upper Body Home Workout, the new video from the creators of the best-selling Fitness Made Simple program. Work out with fitness celebrity John Basedow at home and learn the keys to sculpting a lean, muscular physique.
The Awesome Hour Upper Body Home Workout provides exercises to help build your chest, back, shoulders, biceps, triceps, and even abs.
Just 1 hour or less for each workout. Now there's no time excuse for not staying in shape. Have your credit card ready and call now to order.
Would you like the power to change from this to this? Join the thousands of men and women who are changing their bodies and lives with our best-selling videos hosted by fitness celebrity John Basedow.
Fitness Made Simple gives you the power to change. The power to change your body, the power to change your life.
Order our power package today and get the original Fitness Made Simple workout and nutrition video, plus AM-PM workouts, John's popular morning and evening exercise video for only $29.95. That's two videos for the price of one. Call now.
Fitness Made Simple, bringing real results to real people.
In the hard-charging world of gay hockey, one player hides a secret.
Pretty much all my life, I've been attracted to girls.
Can he ever be straight with his teammates? Plus, Ray Liotta, The Daily Show with Jon Stewart, tonight at 11, only on Comedy Central.
dinner smells delicious.
Actually, that's Monday's breakfast. I always stay 5 meals ahead.
Isn't that carrying anal retentive micromanagement to a near sociopathic extreme?
Yes, thanks! Oh, Corny, it's so liberating to have an intelligent conversation free from the pornographic bleedings of a certain mallard-adjusted manure mouth.
Duckman's not here.
The most beautiful words in the English language!
Has it occurred to you that he may be missing, even in trouble, perhaps lying injured somewhere in a rat-infested gutter?
Yes, but I try not to get my hopes up.
Greetings, y'all. It's great to be back in the bosom of...
Duckman? Duckman?
Sometimes he hangs on bosom.
My family! Connectomy! You probably came here wondering what happened to me.
Bernice invited me for dinner.
Okay, I'll tell you. I went for a walk. Nothing unusual happened. I went for a walk.
He may be an idiot, but he sure has a way with an anecdote. Let's eat!
Would you like to play a game of solitaire?
Speaking of food, we're coming along quite nicely on our science fair project of reanimating dead tissue.
You boys win any more of those fairs, and the other students are gonna call the police.
Queen of Hearts Water Service.
Come on in!
I had a really good day at school.
Ajax, it's Saturday. There was no school.
Perhaps that explains why today's lesson was getting rolled for your pocket change by unwashed ne'er-do-wells lying drunk in the playground.
Well, did you communicate this with law enforcement officials? Telephone the proper public uniformed authorities?
Call the police!
Been having some problems with a rental property recently. The tenants want to get out of their lease, which was poorly drafted by my lawyer. It's a terrible lease, just awful.
Isn't that a little harsh, Cornfed?
Well, as my Ozark mama would say, what else you gonna call the police?
Look, on a whim, I arranged my potatoes into a Queen of Hearts.
That looks like fun!
Anything that much fun is probably illegal.
Well then, call the police!
Call the police!
Notify the constabulary.
From the cadence of his voice, I suspected Duckman was either brainwashed or constipated. Then I realized it was both. Deciding to deal with the brainwashing first, I needed to know for what purpose, so I substituted a harmless gag exploding device. Now comes the difficult part, deprogramming Duckman. We'll have to tear apart his entire value system, resulting in emotional and physical trauma, possibly even a complete nervous breakdown.
Let's party!
I don't understand it. Nothing seems to have an effect.
Perhaps we're overlooking a basic concept. You can't break down Dad's value system.
Because Dad doesn't have any values.
Of course. We'll have to torture him into having values, then tear them apart. Government is a necessary structure to impose on an otherwise unruly society.
No!
People want to do good.
No!
Mankind has evolved into a highly intelligent life form.
No!
The human body is not for eating.
I can't take it anymore! You're right!
All government is corrupt.
No!
People are out to get you.
No!
Mankind is a self-destructive species that will kill itself off.
No!
The human body is mostly not for eating.
No! I tried to kill my best friend. I'm scum. I'm some scum. I'm a wasted, worthless wreck of a duck.
Well, he's back to normal.
I can't live with this. I'm gonna kill myself. I'm gonna go out right now and kill myself. And none of you better try to stop me. You're right, Corny. I shouldn't blame myself.
Yes.
We'd like a map of the city.
Map? As one might find in an auto club. An auto club that's not a front for anything. Like, say, this auto club. Just a moment.
Brace yourself. We're probably standing over a trap door. That's a refreshing change.
Good work bringing corn-fed here, Duckman. All on-site assassination victims are recycled in the company compost heap. Hey, Getz! You fools! That's for killing Charlie Rose! This is corn-fed!
Sorry. Our mistake.
Duckman, stop. Where are you gonna get another sidekick? Andy Richter's booked. Andy Devine's dead. Andy McDowell isn't a sidekick.
Luckily, I wax my throat every morning in case of just such an ironic situation.
Hooves, do your stuff. That wasn't Iggy Catalpa at all, just a robotic surrogate designed by the WDL to add one more pointless plot twist to this overwrought conspiracy. It's finally over. Duckman, do you know what this means?
Free maps!
Right. That and the most fiendish organization ever to plague humanity has been destroyed.
Oh, good. By the way, Corny, sorry about that little mix-up at dinner last night.
When you tried to kill me?
Let's not quibble over details. The important thing is, when it comes to you and me, nothing can interfere with... Ooh, free trip planners.
Yes, well, thanks to us, people can now go to bed knowing that their lives are truly their own, that the world can write its own destiny, that we are no longer the pawns and puppets of evil worldwide conspiracies.
Excellent. Everything went according to plan.
Good. They don't suspect a thing.
Perfect. They're right where we want them.
You gelling?
No telling how much I'm gelling. You gelling?
I'm gelling like a felon.
Quit yelling, we're gelling.
Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are so soft, they make any shoe feel outrageously comfortable. Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's.
Hey, here's Bob, the host with the most, you might say. And here's his buddy, Tom. Looks like Tom could use a little help. So Bob did the buddy thing and told Tom to call and order Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. Well, Tom got his Enzyte, and look at him now. Yes, in just a few short weeks, he's stepping large and laughing easy. Enzyte is not available in stores. Try now for only $29.95 per month. Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement. This is Bob. Bob is looking cool. And with a call to Enzyte about natural male enhancement, Bob is living large. In a few short weeks, Bob has a big new spring of confidence, a generous swelling of pride, and the one thing every man deserves, a little well-earned respect from the neighborhood. Enzyte is not available in stores. Try now for only $29.95 per month. Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement.
Finest minds of our age.
This is Comedy Central.
And let's get this dance party a dancing.
I was putting my body in motion, and I apparently